way down. It's way down. What about now? Is that better? I should be louder than it. I'll turn it down a bit more. What about that? Okay, sorry guys. Hold on, give me a minute to set up the lights and stuff. Just wanted to get started, you know? Don't go anywhere. Find stuff we should react to. What should we do? Figure out what we should do, guys. Be right back. Talk about grinds yet, bro? I posted a video that's got like 90k on it. Nah, these are not my beats. I'm just playing like a random vaporwave mix. I could play my stuff, but that's not really fun. Who likes listening to their own music, dude? That's like, we could do that though, because I would like to avoid getting copyrighted, which I probably already am getting copyrighted. Here, I'm gonna play my own music. There we go. Playing my own music now. What do you mean by homeless? I mean, I was living in a hotel for like 3 days and I almost couldn't get one the first day. Like, I was actually homeless and I had to have rehab so far. I'm not in rehab, bro. You ain't ever been homeless? Bro, I was living in a hotel. Are you serious? I was living in a fucking hotel for like 3 days. I had to find a room and I had to like grind. I had to grind to find a room. I had to like call like 100 people. I'll just play my music. Everything's all right. Yeah, everything's pretty settled now. I just had to move out.
Yeah.
On the plus side, the so this is actually my music here. Let's see. How'd you become homeless in the span of 4 days? I basically just had to move out and I didn't have anywhere to go. I became unhomeless when I moved into a room. What I was gonna say though is the spot I'm actually at is actually pretty good. Like the internet's way better. Like it actually has better upload and download than my old spot. Okay, hold on. I'm still setting everything up. Just set the lights up. Just gotta set the camera real quick and then we're good to go. I'll try to find stuff we should react to and whatnot. All right, we're about to start, guys. Yeah.
Since we're all going in the same direction, might as well go together.
Yes, this is actually my music in the background. Okay. Okay, we're about to start here. So I was setting up the camera and the lights. I just wanted to press the starting soon thing soon. It is not abnormal for people to do the starting soon thing for over 10 minutes. It's been 14, so one person watching, bro, fell off. How you guys doing? Okay, well, this is not set up. I'm going to have to mess with some things here. Camera. Okay, there we go. There I am. I'm going to have to mess with the green screen stuff. Okay, the auto white balance. I'm going to have to mess with that real quick. All right, how you guys doing today? How you guys doing, chat? Let's try this one here. I could put on the, what do you call, the ultra, the wide angle. This is a bit closer than normal. What do you guys think? Should I put on the wide lens? Maybe I'll put on the wide lens. I gotta reset the green screen. Immersion is off, yeah. Uninspired, how come? RX 11 stinks. Wait, didn't RX, did that just come out? Wait, hold on. Do I have that already? I think I have that. Oh, they released RX 11? Not. Hold on. Oh, wow. Dude, RX 10 sucked. What was wrong with them? RX 10 was garbage. What the fuck? They released RX 11? Let me grab the lighting. Bro, they're making such a mistake with what they're doing. It's a 451 here right now. They're making such a mistake with like the whole like parsing out releases and then like barely upgrading anything. Zoom in a bit. I gotta fix the green screen. It's all messed up. You have a shadow? I know I have a shadow on the green screen. Oh my god. Hey, thank you for that. I didn't know. I had no idea until you just told me. Let's see. Home key. Okay, hold on a second. Let me fix this here, guys. Like I said, I'm in a new location here, so everything's a bit different. Also, there's like blue. The room is like painted blue. So that might be throwing off the color a little bit. I'm gonna have to reset the chroma key color. Okay, that's a lot better. All right, how you guys doing today? Let me turn down the music a little bit. Okay, let's see. Okay, should we check out RX 11? What should we do right now today, guys? I didn't even know that came out. Spill reduction. Probably something like that's good. Okay, we're set. It was a fake studio this whole time. No. No, it was not. Hold on. You got something on Twitch. Hey, thank you, Tim. Thank you, Tim. I appreciate that. Let me get the sound effects going. Where is it? Where did I put it? Yo, thank you, Tim. Appreciate that. For the 5 gifted tier 1 subs, man. Looks like you dyed your hair. No, I just got out of the shower. I'm on my grind. I appreciate that, Tim. For real. Yeah, they released RX, or they're peaking, or doing something to RX 11. Yeah, any donations, subs, I appreciate that, dude. That's helping me. People ask if I have a day job. I'm making a decent income from YouTube, but like I just make just enough for like rent and food. Like I'm like paycheck to paycheck, basically. But I got to get on my grind, basically. Who are your favorite music tutorial content creators? In terms of like quality, I think ArtFX does a good job. NaviD does a decent job. Who else? I don't know. Who else is good? I don't know. It's really hit or miss with people. I want to say I love your content. Thank you, man. Appreciate that. Let's see. So yeah, I was kind of homeless for like a few days. I had like 2 or 3 days where I was living in a hotel trying to find a spot because I had to get a new spot to stay at. I found a spot across the island. And it's actually kind of better. The internet, I think, is better. The upload and download is better. There's more room for the green screen, so the green screen is like even more set than normal. Isn't half of Hawaii like homeless? It's something like that. Music production streams are the way to go in regards to tutorials. I'm trying to think who else is good. Name some names, guys. I'll tell you what I think. I'm pretty picky with that. Like, I wouldn't watch BWB, you know, not unironically. John Makes Beats is pretty good, but he doesn't, it's not really tutorials. Alchemy is pretty quality.
Hey, Busy.
Super Chat, $5. Hope all is welcome. Love the content. Thank you, Valentin. Appreciate that, man. Do you know Be the Lick? No. Do your neighbors hate you? No, not yet. Let's see. Zimworld is pretty good. Zimworld's okay. I really think you and Venus Siri have the best videos. I like Venus Siri for sure. Okay, I think we're pretty set here. I think we're gonna do something now. So I guess we'll check out RX11. I used to fuck with your beats too. Yeah, I used to fuck with them too, dude. Honestly, your content is great. I'm so sick of the short clickability, or I think clickbaity hacks for 808, etc. Stranger's pretty good, yeah. Do you have pets? Nah, I used to have a cat before. Venus is a new vid out. What's rent for a one bedroom out there? I'm paying $12.50, but it's for me and my girlfriend. So it's decently expensive. You know, people talk about the cost of living in Hawaii. You know what's really expensive in Hawaii? Well, let me just show you guys what it's like out here. You know what's really the real cost of living in Hawaii, though? Sauce, man. Sauce. You go to Jack in the Box, they're charging you 25 cents per sauce. You want four buttermilks? That's going to be an extra dollar, sir. That's the cost of living in Hawaii. They're like, yeah, gas, whatever. It's kind of the same price as Cali. You know, rent's maybe a little more expensive, but the real problem is the sauce, man. Just eat at home at that point. Okay, hold on. Hawaii. Hold on, let me just get you guys way back here. Probably just use coconut oil. Okay, here you go, guys. Hold on, I got an idea here. That's cheap compared to LA and New York. Dude, you don't even have to play in a lot of those places, I thought. Pay for, like, sauce, that is. Okay, here you go, guys. Let me just, I got something for you here. You're gonna like this. I think you guys are gonna like this. One second, I'm cooking here. I'm cooking. He's a cooking. I wish I could have done this. I gotta learn how to use studio mode in OBS so I could do this faster. All right, guys, this is my new spot. Hold on. This would work a lot better if I had it prepared already. Hold on. Where did I put it? Hold on. I'm still moving it. All right, there we go, guys. Ugh, I got my new spot here. What are you guys thinking? What are you guys thinking of the new crib? You know, people are like, hey, do you live on a hut on the beach? And I'm like, yeah. Yeah, I do live on a hut on the beach. Can you see that right now? Yeah. Okay. Let's see. I'm digging this spot though. There's way more room. Like I actually roll back. Hold on. I have to zoom in a little bit. Because before the green screen was like literally like right behind my back. And like I couldn't even do this. Like I couldn't even do that. But now I can just get up and walk around, really. It's actually pretty rad. I could just do this and... I can actually grab the camera and bring it with me. It's low-key dope. Dude, this spot's way better. Plus, the internet is better. Like, from what I can tell, the upload and download speed is better. Okay. All right, let's check out RX 11. Let me just change the title of the stream real quick. Okay, 1 second. Stand-up setting coming. The real problem with that is the green screen is only 6 feet tall and I'm 6'4". We're working on this type 5. Let's see. Let's check out Izotope RX11. I could also put I was homeless, but now I'm checking out our Izotope RX11. Calm height flex. I'm not trying to height flex. Actually, sometimes I kind of wish I was shorter for the green screen. That would make it a little bit easier. I was homeless, but now I'm checking out Izotope RX11. I wonder if they will send me it if I apologize to that guy for making fun of his eye bags. I said eye bags. All right, guys. Okay, let me just change the YouTube stream title, and then we're going to change what we're working on here. So far, this is looking good. What cares about RX7? Why is it we're not discussing Annalie Choppa OnlyFans? What are you talking about? Annalie Choppa OnlyFans? I don't care about that. Are you serious? I don't think you're serious. Okay, one second here. Okay, let's go. Okay, Izotope Arcs 11. Should probably switch this. I guess we gotta do this. Okay, Izotope Arcs 11 coming soon. Let me move this here. What is happening over here? Why is it like this? Why are you like this? Oh, okay, okay. Okay, sweet. 2024, the year all real musicians realize our real futures. What do you mean by that? Margaritaville? Yeah, that's what I got going on right now. Let me move this one thing real quick, and then we're doing the RX 11. Imagine I'm just stalling forever, and we're never going to do the RX 11. I didn't know about this. How did no one tell me about this? You guys got to be messaging me stuff like this or tweeting at me. Get a sneak peek at RX 11. All right, so what are you guys hoping for in RX 11? Because RX 11 was really disappointing, in my opinion. RX 10, I mean, and RX 9. Basically, every RX was really disappointing, in my opinion. Well, let me just turn this up. Let me get the volume right. Play something. And one more. Okay. GG. And one more. Okay, cool. Dig arcs for post-production, but goddamn, it's too expensive. There are some good tools in it, like mouth declick, the declicking tools, declip, etc. Declipping kind of fucks up the audio, though, a lot, but a lot of them are pretty good. One thing I've always been disappointed with them, though, is the separation algorithms. They've been really shitty since ARC 7 or 8 or whatever. Whenever they introduced it, they haven't made it better since then. Like, declick is, like, usually the most useful thing for me in there. Should I still turn it down a little bit? A little more. Like that. These plugins are boring. AI music is where it's at. These plugins are boring. I'm just AI generating music these days. The adaptive phase tool is amazing. I haven't used that. But yeah, they haven't updated the music separation algorithm since ARC 7, right? And like, that's... I don't understand why they haven't done that. They should. Okay, let's see what's going on this page here. Get a sneak peek at RX 11, get an early preview of some of the features coming soon at RX 11, then clean up your tracks faster than ever, and for a limited time, buy RX 10 now and get the equivalent version of RX 11 for free next month. So, like, are they going to... Hopefully, they're going to tell us what's good in it. Like, are they just trying to get people to buy it early? Okay, this May, award-winning audio repair goes to 11. What? Okay, yeah. Good to know. Can we know what it is first, please? Let's see, industry first tech upgraded machine learning, fully revamped repair assistant. Okay, fully revamped repair assistant, that's good. I wonder what that really entails though, right? ARX 11 elements, next generation of repair assistant. Let's look. Bait and switch. Because I'm basically thinking it's just going to be ARX 10 with like a few things maybe upgraded a little bit. That's generally what they've been doing lately. Always beware of elements. I agree. Elements is always like a, it's not a scam, but it's a scheme in order to get you to buy the cheap version or get it for, or like, because it, basically it's like so limited. You can't do anything with it. What's Stem Sator? Stem Separator is good and will phase against the original. I think the best one currently is Ultimate Vocal Remover because it's free and they have different algorithms you can switch out. Okay, so they don't really have any information here. It's just repairs, the RX 10 repair assistant. Don't care. Okay, RX 11 standard. We'll have two new tools apparently. Do they say what it is? They don't say what it is, dude. This is such a... Hold on, I gotta turn down the music. This is still like a little too loud for me. This is such a scam, in my opinion. Let me pick something. This is such a scam, in my opinion, because it's like, bro, like, why are you selling a new version? And like, you're not even saying what is going to be in it, you know, like, why are you like being like, hey, buy it now, you get the free upgrade, but we can't tell you what's in it yet. Like, get people excited about it, man, unless it's not really that exciting. I don't think it's really that exciting. So they do say there's two new tools in here. They could be shitty tools, though. They probably are shitty tools. They probably are shitty tools, if we're being honest here. Hey, thank you for the $5 super chat underscore. Yo, Weaver, let me know when you want to pop out to LA or Lanai. Oh, hell yeah. That's cool. Probably not anytime soon, but yeah, I'm just, I'm in Kailua right now. Don't want to give more information than that, but, yeah, no, the Outer Islands are pretty sick, man. How long you been out there? Izotope has just gotten shittier over time. So RX 11 Advanced, they say they have real-time dialogue isolation. cutting edge neural network that provide neural network stuff is pretty crazy. I think that's the new thing, because the neural filters on Photoshop are crazy. Cutting edge neural network is neural just like AI? Is neural network stuff? Hold on. Is neural network AI? A method in artificial intelligence. I figured. A method in our artificial intelligence teaches computers to process data in a way that is inspired by the human brain. So it's basically artificial. It's just artificial intelligence. It's another word for artificial. That's going to be the new buzzword, guys. New buzzword is going to be neural network or neural something. Yeah, it's a new buzzword for AI. About a year, I'll cover your trip. I need you 12-10% for WNN. I wish I could say yes to that. I got my girlfriend with me, though. And I don't know. I just like paying for my own stuff. Just polished machine learning. I appreciate the offer, though. That's awesome. Okay, let's see. So RX11 dialogue isolation, that's actually pretty good. So this is gonna be like cleaning up noise, I'm guessing. Maybe something kind of like the Adobe podcast thing. I don't know if you guys remember that before. I don't know if they still do that, the Adobe podcast AI. Basically it takes audio, and I don't even know how it works, but it like cleans it up a lot. Adobe Enhanced. Did they change the name of it? Or was it always Enhanced and it's just under Adobe Podcast? Oh, okay. Yeah, I remember I used it one time and it was crazy. It's good for Zoom audio. So like if you're using like a Zoom recorder. The neural filters for noise and portraits are really good in Photoshop. Yeah, dude, the stuff they got in Photoshop is pretty crazy right now. That's the kind of stuff I want to see with AI, you know, like the generative stuff that helps creators, but not in a way that like takes away creativity. It just helps you do like the menial work of like, you know, cloning something or whatever, or trying to like work around some bullshit. And also like stuff that just enhances like what we're already doing, you know. Sunu also UDO is scary. It produces full songs that are passable. Now I want to say they're passable. We actually did that one of the last streams. I can kill the high end sometimes. Can you consolidate the chats from different platforms? I do have them. They are consolidated here. It's both YouTube and Twitch. It's pretty awesome. It was kind of hard to get it set up, though. I used Restream to do it. So yeah, they're doing this dialogue isolation sounds cool, but I don't know if it's gonna be worth like $300 or whatever the upgrade price is. Do they have the upgrades available? So the offer expires May 14th. I'm assuming it's probably gonna come out May 14th. That's why the offer expires then. Is there more information on it? Okay, there's also a new high quality processing mode, unlocks new possibilities for recovering dialogue and vocals captured in less than ideal conditions. That's actually pretty awesome, but I feel like this is gonna not be worth the amount of money that they're gonna be charging. Let's see. Okay, so you save up to 50% of RX10, plus you get RX11 for free. So they don't say how much it is yet. So we don't really know a lot about it. Is this the same link? Does this take us back to the same place? This is not a sneak peek at RX11. This is very disappointing, if I'm being honest here. Let's see what else they're saying in other places. When will RX11 be released? I just hope RX11 coming soon. RX11 pre-sale here. Let's try to find some stuff about this, guys. Okay, so this is from Reddit. This is 6 months ago, though, so that's probably useless. Okay, let's see what they're saying on GearSpace. Apparently, it'll release around May, June. Maybe someone's got some leaks here or something, right? An updated, better unmixed function would be welcomed. Yeah, I agree. They're way behind with the stem separator. I don't think it'll be worth the money. Yeah, I agree. It'll probably be worth the money, if you know what I mean. It'll be worth the money. If you get what I'm saying. You know, it's worth extended free trial money. Let's see. There's not really any information on this. So this is like, we don't really got much here.
Used on countless albums.
This isn't even RX11 here, is it? Hold on. Let me see if I can figure out if this is RX11 in this. We can't even tell if this is RX11 in this picture here. So there's not really a lot of information on it, man. Not much. Okay, so there's a new Bad Gear video. What else could we check out today, guys? Let's see. I was going to do a video about the Kendrick Lamar Drake diss track situation. I don't know if it's too late, though. I don't know. I already did a video about the Grimes thing. So how can I extend my free trials? I can't tell if you're serious or not. When I say extended free trial. Come on, You know what I'm talking about, right? When I say extended free trial, you're not getting it directly from the company. You're getting an extended free trial, and it lasts forever. It's an extended free trial that lasts for fucking ever, all right? Even the ads are AI generated. How can, let's see, what do you think about Venus's digital minimalism video? Maybe we can watch that next. AI and neural network do have different, did any other plugins come out, guys, or anything? Let's see, YouTube has failed music producers. This might be interesting. Boosted trial, prompt us to make a gospel anthemic, type song for talking about my CSR at a day job, a sponsored stream. No, this is not sponsored. This is sponsored by the beach. The beach, bruh. Visco? What about Visco? I did a WNN talking about it. I've actually utilized it to generate some drum samples and stuff. It's pretty good. I have it. I actually have it. If we wanna check it out. Aloha is right. Sponsored by Extended Free Trial. Sponsored by R2R, baby. Sponsored by R2R. Let me get zoom in a little more. Hold on. Do you get sponsor offers? I do, but I'm very weary of them. Okay, let's see. Flex is a new Omnisphere. Bro, Larry O is like the king of reaching here. Wait, hold on. Larry O is becoming the king of reaches here. Like, what is this? Flex is the new Omnisphere? Like, bro, how hard can you suck off FL Studio and just, like, come to a conclusion that no one believes in? Like, it's a problem with making, like, an FL Studio podcast. You just have to have more and more insane takes about FL Studio that are just nonsense. And, like, Omnisphere's not even that good, in my opinion. It's not the GOAT or anything. Right, producers shouldn't sign production deals. What else we got? Let me see. Venus Theory video. The new Luet mic with self-auto gain is everywhere. The Flex UI looks shite. It looks okay to me. It kind of reminds me of Thor. What's better, the door closing samples or ring the bell? Are you talking about like when you're trying to fuck with people on stream? Penis Theory. Yeah, we could do Penis Theory. I haven't watched this Vaporwave one either. I don't know. It doesn't really interest me that much. Okay. I don't dislike Larry O though. He gave me this cool mouse pad. So I'm going to have to forever suck his dick for the rest of my life. I'm going to have to suck his dick for the rest of my life because he gave me some mouse pads. I don't even need mouse pads. But they have like, I don't know, all the Ableton shortcuts on them. So I got to suck his dick for the rest of my life. Sorry, guys. Venus Theory on his villain arc right now. All right. Well, me and him should team up. I need some more villains in my life. And now it's starting to drop more stuff. Soon, 15 coming soon. All right, let's see here. Let me switch this to YouTube. God, he's always got the weird fucking... God, I love Venus Theory, but he's such a fucking hipster, dude. Like, what is this aspect ratio of his videos? Alice Yalfin had an interesting... Isn't it Yalfin? Had an interesting video on her being afraid of AI. Okay, maybe we could check that out, too. I'm not gonna lie. Her voice fucks with me, dude. Oh my God. Did not mean to misgender there. Her voice fucks with me. Like, it's really hard for me to, like, get past the voice. Like, and it's not, it has nothing to do with, like, being trans or anything. It's just, like, it's, if anything, I hate people from other countries. That's what it is. Nah, I don't hate people from other countries, but it's just hard for me to, like, get past the voice. And I feel like chat, I don't know if they can too, but we could try it, watch it. I do like her videos, though. Her videos are well created. Okay, Penis Theory is a terrible hipster. No, he's a good hipster. He's a very strong hipster. Okay, digital minimalism is making me a better musician. Let's check it out. What up?
Let's use upright bass from Native Instrument. POV, your necklace
breaks on stuff. If there's one source...
And yeah, I fucking hate Italian people. The joke is I'm Italian. She worries that AI has gotten too close to sounding real. I think the real problem with AI, bro, is the fucking... the diss track situation we have going on with Drake and Kendrick. Like, people weren't sure if that Drake diss track was real. Then there was, like, people making fake ones. Bro misgendered again. It's Jover. Did I? No, I didn't. Did you just call him Penis Theory? I'm making the call-out post on Twitter as we speak. Do it. Do it. I need more controversy. I'll apologize. I don't give a shit. Let's see. Okay.
Of the most
Jordan's new hip hop video. Oh, he told me to react to it. He actually wanted me to react to the beat and then put in his video, but I was fucked the past few days. Like I said, I was like homeless for a few days, and then I just had a lot going on.
Misery in my life.
Okay, so Venus Theory, digital minimalism is making me a better musician.
It's probably this thing.
Testing.
And I don't think I'm alone in this.
This week on the evening news, we've been reporting on internet addictions on a mom who spent 50 hours a week playing an online game.
50 hours a week playing an online game? Dude, that's a whole fucking full-time job.
No.
Like, I feel like you can only get addicted to this kind of stuff if you have enough freedom in your life to not be like homeless and shit like that. I'm not saying all addictions are like that, but I feel like you can only get addicted to like a fucking mobile game or some bullshit if you really have nothing else going on in your life and you have nothing, you can't get thrown out of your house or anything. Like, you have to have like very limited issues to like fuck up your life with something like that. The Jordan video is sort of just a track loop commercial. It's decent though. All right. I hate that. I kind of, that's one reason I hate sponsorships. It just feels like a way to ninja in an ad for a company, you know? I kind of prefer when the ad is unrelated to the video. It's just like a quick 1 minute thing, and then you could skip it if you want to. You know, I hate when it's like integrated into the video.
So I decided to do something about it. In the last few weeks, I've introduced a few simple digital minimalist practices in my life that have helped me to not only break.
I was watching this video recently that I think I reacted to on my second channel. I can't remember the name of it, but it was like a guy doing like a knockoff Venus Theory thing, except he was using his all footage of like, it was all stock footage, and it was also really generic and like really hypocritical. It's funny when people try to do knockoff Venus Theory videos, it doesn't work.
My habits have passed.
Like, he does it really well. Like, it just, it comes off genuine. It like having the footage of himself works really well too. Like, cause I feel like the stock footage, like if you don't have the right clips, it really just like breaks the immersion. And like, if you're doing something serious, it doesn't feel that serious anymore.
Of content consumption, but improve my focus and workflow, make me more intentional with my.
Yeah, the dude with the bad voiceover, the guy sounded like he was like doing like a corpse husband thing. He's like, the downfall of music producers.
My use of technology helped me to become more creative and gain 10 pounds of pure American muscle.
All right, okay. Between him and Navi D, dude, I'm fucking scared, all right? Do not. Oh, man, that would be quite the team, dude, to have Navi D and Venus Theory want to kick your ass.
Okay.
And Ben Jordan. Oh, my God, because Ben Jordan boxes. So you got Ben Jordan, Navi D, and Venus Theory. Don't fuck with them, all right? Don't fuck with them. The three of them get together, you are dead.
Well, at least most of that's true.
And yeah, I know the whole, like, millennial does video on digital minimalism, social media bad, her is very funny, and you're very clever for pointing that out, but just hear me out, because if you're a creator like me...
Dude, his beard and I know this is just, like, super random commentary right now, but his beard and mustache is fucking ridiculous, dude. Like, that is... Holy shit, he needs to tone that down, dude.
I think this shit's pretty important. Over the last few months...
If you have BWB on your side, see, he'll just pay them. He'll just pay them to make them go away. So having BWB on your side is actually a good thing. He will just pull out money and then pay them to fuck off.
I've noticed that I've started to develop some pretty bad habits with my relationship with technology. And I'm not sure why, but it just came to light for me that a lot of my overuse of my devices and stuff...
Should have put porn on the screen. Would have been better with porn on the screen.
...stuff was for no real function...
Dude, imagine having four things open at once like this, dude. Oh my God. You're two shave strokes away from having the same goatee. True.
...general reason. For whatever reason, I just started to create too many distractions for myself from the creative process. And being someone who creates things, that's not good. And because of these habits I developed, I noticed that I started to just sort of gaslight myself into second guessing my ability to do anything creative. It was this really weird spot between like imposter syndrome and sort of a...
It's always funny. I don't know if you guys have ever tried to do this before, but you try to like shave like your, you know, beard or something like that to like look like someone else because you're trying to pull a thing. Like the time I tried to look like the needle drop and then I ended up just looking like Walter White. That was good. That was good. It's kind of funny because like I was like imagining like, what if I like shave my shit to be like Venus Theory and then... You know, to like look like him, and I'm like, what if I just end up looking like someone else? Like
Dunning-Kruger effect. That's at least the best I can explain it. And I'm not sure why that is, but I think it's because I started to rely on this passive intake of information as sort of this crutch and thereby associate this mindless consumption with part of what it means to be productive as a creator. I'm sure it's a feeling you know all too well. I would be writing a...
Reaper. Yeah, it's a feeling I know all too well. Wanting to...
Song or working on a video or...
I know that feeling too well when I open Reaper.
Something, I would get stuck, open YouTube for some ideas or inspiration, and then end up watching tutorials for hours on end and then just become overwhelmed instead of actually inspired. And because of this, like a lot of you, at least based on what I've seen on comments on this channel, I developed this pretty toxic line of thinking where I would find myself second-guessing any idea I had or decision I would make throughout the creative process and weigh it against this imaginary, like, person or audience or...
Nah, it's not because Reaper's boring. I don't know. I just prefer Ableton. I don't know,
framework or...
I don't want to customize my fucking DAW. I just want it to work. I just want it to work. I want to be comfortable with it.
Algorithm or whatever you want to call it, just this faceless entity thing. And it was because there was this voice in the back of my head constantly saying something to the effect of, if you're not doing things this specific way, then you can't possibly be doing them right. And when it comes to creative work, that's a pretty dumb way to think. When it comes to getting started with digital minimalism, there's a lot of information on how to get started.
I feel like digital minimalism is just, like, what information do you need? Just use your shit less. I don't know. Just use your phone less. Use all your shit less. All your electronics, use them less. I don't know. Like, what's really... What more information do you need?
All this, and I think there's some great...
Yeah, I'm more of a digital maximalist right now. I have the TV on. I'm not even watching it. I got light shining in my face. I got fucking two monitors on. I have shit on I'm not even using right now.
Advice and some not so good advice, but there is also just a lot of advice. From trying a lot of this out myself over...
Press one in the chat if we should put Subway Surfers on the screen. Should we bring back the engagement corner? Press one. I will buy it if we have enough ones. I think people are going to want the engagement corner. I'm just going to get the footage now. There should be Tinder for Producers. There actually is, to be honest. There is. I can't remember what it's called. I saw it in a Bolo video. Yep, I knew people were going to do this, dude. Footage. Yeah, I'm already getting it out. And I'm going to put CSGO on the screen. All right, guys. Thanks for this. All right, let me make it smaller real quick. Please, no. There's only one person that's like, please don't fucking do that. Everyone else is just like, yes, for the love of God. Okay, so I'm going to put that in CSGO. I'm going to put CSGO footage also. ADHD save. You guys are welcome. And I can put lava lamp footage behind me. So CSGO surfing. Okay, hold on. You prefer Minecraft? No, we're doing CSGO surfing. That's what I prefer. This is exactly what the video is talking about. That's the whole point. That's why it's funny. 1 hour CSGO surfing. Okay, I'm going to capture both of these real quick. Well, let me just window capture these and then we're set. Sorry, guys. This is going to take a second. It's worth it, though. It's absolutely worth it. Add a lava lamp. No. Gone. I got to put this on screen real quick. Let's see. Window capture. And then, okay. We got this here. And I'm going to need another window capture. It's going to be worth it, guys. Hold on. Give me a second here. And then 1 hour CSGO surfing. This is worth it. This is super worth it right now. Okay, then I'm gonna have to write engagement corner also. so people know, you know, when they pop in here, they're gonna be like, oh yeah, the engagement corner. I love that. I love that thing. Engagement corner is really awesome. You think that's too small, guys? That's too small of an engagement corner? Are you gonna be engaged? Should I also put cute animals, petting cute animals? Yeah, I mean, that gives you a lot to focus on there, you know? I can feel myself developing ADHD. Well, I'm sorry to tell you this. If you're watching me, you already have it. Okay, okay, one more. I'll do one more. I'll do, and then we'll also do, bro, I'm so engaged. I'm so engaged right now, too. There's so much to focus on. I think I might get on TikTok, too, at the same time. More screens. We were 2-2 video on there. That's actually really funny. Okay, guys, press 1 if we should do cute animal videos, or press 2 if we should do a Weaver Beats 2 video in the engagement corner. I'm thinking too, because that's really funny just to have my own video there. Is there a way I can just play all of them back to back? Okay, here we go.
Mom, know that you're playing with a sex offender.
Does your mom know you're playing with a sex offender? Okay, here we go. All right, and then let me just window capture that, and then we're basically set. This is worth it, guys. We're gonna lose some viewers here, but I think everyone's gonna be really happy. These viewers are gonna be really engaged. Twerk video. We can't put twerk video compilation. That's for sure gonna get banned. You gotta play the other vid that has engagement corner. That's pretty good, but yeah, no, we can't. That's too much. That's too much setup. I can't do that right now. Okay, almost done. Almost done. Let me just. Whoop, whoop, whoop. And oh no. Okay, let's set this up here. And then we got a right engagement corner. Not enough Family Guy clips. Well, we don't have the sound, so I don't think Family Guy clips are gonna be that good. Okay, here we go. And then we got a right engagement corner. So that's important. Let's see. Engagement corner. You're welcome. I feel like it's kind of offensive to Venus Theory, but whatever. It's not your fault, Venus Theory. It's my chat. My chat, there's something wrong with us, you know? There's just something wrong with us. That's really the issue here. It's not you, it's us. This guy's a shill, boo. I agree. I'm so engaged. Dude, I am so engaged right now. I don't even know what's happening anymore. This is fucking stupid. I don't know what to tell you, man. This is not peak highbrow comedy here, all right? This is more of like a lowbrow, like you're returning sort of channel, you know? If this is stupid to you, it's because it is. You're 2 pixels too small. Okay, whatever. Okay, we're good. We're continuing now, guys.
The last few weeks, I found some things that worked and some things that just didn't. So from all of that, I wanted to just share 5 sort of rules and key ideas that I found to be most effective that I think would help you if you're looking to get started. Number 1 is creating phone-free zones. For me, this means things like...
God, it seems like such a hipster thing. This is a phone-free zone. This thing? No. Get rid of that. This is a phone-free zone, all right? I don't care if your child is dying. No phones allowed, all right?
When I first wake up and right before... Before I'm about to go to bed.
Your head is chopped off on cam. But the problem is, like, I can't really... The camera's just really close. I mean, I could, like, get a further away from my computer. I get it now. The engagement cord is needed.
So no more checking your phone as soon as you wake up, and no more mindless midnight doom scrolling. My studio space is another big one, so I consciously try to avoid bringing my phone into my studio at least as much as possible so I can really focus on the work I'm doing. And of course, there is the biggest time waster of all, so don't bring your phone if you're about to go see a man about a horse.
I mean, that's true. Like, if I'm bringing, like, something to the toilet, like my phone or Nintendo Switch or something, I'm just gonna spend much more time there than I should be. When's the next Wave Wars? I think it's gonna be this Monday. I think it's gonna be this Monday, unless something comes up. It's gonna be Monday. I gotta edit the past one, so. Cam is still boarding an engagement party. It's not, it's that we have ADHD, all right? It's because we have ADHD.
Number 2 is scheduling and being more intentional about the time you use.
It'd be super funny if you do follow these rules. Like, you're like, okay, I'm not gonna bring my phone on the toilet anymore. I'm not gonna do that. But then instead you just like do shit like fucking go to sleep on the toilet. It's like, man, I don't know why. I'm just wasting so much time on the toilet. I don't know what's happening. I don't know what's going on.
Devices. So if you have to do things like...
I read music theory on the toilet. I read sheet music on the toilet.
Maybe check social
media. Get on my fucking level.
Try not to do that until at least maybe sometime in the afternoon. I would also really recommend trying a sort of...
I should probably notify the Discord. Sorry, I didn't notify the Discord we're streaming. Let me do that. Did you do that? Oh, Twitch notification. Now let me do at here. I am streaming right now. Sorry, guys. I didn't do this. I meant to. YouTube and Twitch. Come hang out with us. I haven't been posting videos or streaming or doing Wave Wars because I was homeless for a few days. All right. I want to know what time we're on. We're on homeless engagement corner time. Let's see. HTTPS, YouTube. Okay, we're almost done. Sorry. This is important. One more people in here. Okay, cool. We're gonna fix everything after stream. You're grounded. What's fixed? What are we fixing? Rule 3, quit watching this dude. Can I submit the AI music that I made? You're gonna have to pay me big butts. Pay me big bucks. I'm gonna need big bucks to be paid to listen to your AI music.
1 week cleanse from any particularly distracting apps or websites, with the only exception being something that has to be used for work-related purposes, like when I need to make a post on Instagram or something, or go on YouTube to post a video. Number 3 is optimizing your phone for focus. Originally for this, I considered down-
You mean no Candy Crush? No Candy Crush?
I'm grading my-
No engagement corner? No engagement corner?
Phone to something like a light phone or a dumb phone, flip phone, or just a really basic Android.
What is a dumb phone?
Device, because I'd seen a lot of other people do that and have some success, but that seemed like a waste of money and just contributes a lot to unnecessary electronic waste, and that seemed kind of dumb. So instead, I changed just 3 settings on my regular phone to make it more of a dumb phone. And let me tell you, this made my phone so much better in like 30 seconds. I think the first step is just remove.
Okay, I'm actually kind of interested in this. How you gonna make your phone a dumb phone? Just bash it? Just bash the shit out of it?
Having any unnecessary or distracting apps, especially if they're.
Does it say OnlyFans there in the right corner? Oh, you can't see it because engagement corner.
There's already a web version available. So with something like Instagram.
This seems like way too many apps.
I could delete that and just use.
What is it of yours that you don't want me to try? Pants or shirts?
Shirts.
And
say.
Okay.
The browser version, and because the browser version of most apps really sucks, then that kind of curbs.
It's like, yeah, I saved so much time from digital minimalism, but I wasted it all making this video.
The habit pretty quickly. The next thing I really liked enabling was Do Not Disturb mode. This allows me to selectively pick which notification.
Being evicted again right now, and my girlfriend was just asking me which clothes of mine she doesn't want me to dry. Or for her to dry.
Notifications are going to come through on my device. So in my case, I just
being evicted again right now. That's really funny. Dude, so far the internet's good, right? Though, like we haven't dropped out at all. It's pretty good. Like, dude, the upload. I kind of want to check the upload. Okay, after we're done with this, I'm gonna check the upload and download speed again because it was like 200 or 300 last night, which is, dude, it was like 100 in my old place.
Enabled calls and texts from any of my contacts. No emails, no Discord, no anything else like that. Another mode I found really helpful is focus mode. This allows me to select any particularly distract.
Is my internet still wireless? It's wireless now, but I had wireless before, but I was using wired.
Apps, so Chrome, Discord, and YouTube in my case. And now if I try to open something like Discord, there's a pop-up that says, do you want to use this? And I can only...
And there's a pop-up that says, hey, fucking idiot. You're doing digital minimalism, all right? No fucking Discord.
Use it for 5 minutes.
New Dawson synth myth just came out 10 minutes ago. What is Dawson synth myth?
Minutes before it's going to remind me that it's time to get back to work. And I think this is great. Finally, the last one I enabled on Android was bedtime mode. This turns the whole phone black and white and removes pretty...
Is he really giving us a tutorial right now on how not to use your phone?
Pretty much all of the visual eye candy that just sucks you in and keeps you attached to your phone. So I just made my phone as boring as possible and Turns out that's actually really effective. If you're an Android user, you might also consider using a minimalist launcher.
Lol. Android user, am I right, guys? I have an Android.
On your device, but it's not really totally necessary. I tried a couple of these out for myself over the course of about a week, and I just didn't really get along.
Holy shit, what if instead of digital minimalism, it was Ohio minimalism, and it made your phone more Ohio? Holy shit, gat. That's Riz.
With any of them, mostly because they didn't seem to support things that I need in terms of functionality for my phone, like having a calendar on the homepage. That's something that's really important to me. So you might try it out and see if it's something that works for you. If you do want to try a minimalist launcher, skibbity. I found that
that's pretty skibbity.
O Launcher and Productivity Launcher were two of the better ones, and they're both free. If you're like me and you're pretty dependent on your smartphone and trying to break that habit, I also found an extra layer of challenge was to treat your phone as a wired phone. So I would just leave it plugged in another room. And this really made me a lot more conscious of how much I was wanting to get up and go check it. And
all I've learned in this video is that Venus 3 has a serious problem with his phone. Need some help, pal.
Kind of made me realize.
Should I use DistroKid or IIPDDS? That last one sounds like some sort of like drug code or something. I wouldn't probably use DistroKid though. I don't know.
Is how ridiculous a lot of them.
What the F, David Blaine, are we watching? Okay, we're watching Venus Theory, but my chat has such bad ADD that we also have the engagement corner going on right now. So we have CSGO surfing, then we have Subway Surfer, and then we have Weaver Beats 2 video. So no matter what, you're gonna feel engaged, all right? Just if you're getting bored by the video, not because there's anything wrong with Venus Theory, but because we have problems with our brains. I see Maddie B in engagement corner. It's me reacting to it. Just look around, all right? You will be okay.
Was. Number four is creating a distraction-free computer environment. Okay. This would be things like using the black and white display mode on your
computer. Oh, the flex there, dude. Oh, the flex, the 300K subs.
Computer, which I found helpful. To keep me more focused when doing things like emails and administrative.
It wouldn't keep me focused. That would keep me fucking, I don't know, wondering if I'm like a time traveler or something. I wouldn't want to be using a black and white computer. That just sounds boring as shit.
Work or writing video scripts. Disabling the notifications is also great because, let's be real, most of them are completely useless.
True. And I hate notifications. I never let the Discord notifications pop up. It's always off.
Found that browser extensions were extremely helpful. In Chrome, I got one to block websites that I found particularly distracting. I also started using an ad blocker as a custom filter for sites I would visit but wanted to minimize certain things I was seeing on them. And I also found this really great extension that takes YouTube and turns it into, well, this. Being someone who's pretty chronic,
you kind of want recommendations sometimes, though. You can't just always. I mean, I wouldn't always do that. Like, you're gonna be out of the fucking loop.
On YouTube,
this video is just how people born before 1980 live. Yeah,
found this one in particular to be really.
I would hope most, like all people, were living like this in 1980. I don't think most of them. Like, I don't think they didn't have YouTube or wireless phones. Well, maybe they have wireless phones, but they have smartphones.
Helpful. It removes all the distractions of YouTube, like the homepage. It removes shorts. It removes the suggested feed. I can even remove things like stats on the video or the comments, which is great because when I would go to YouTube to look up a specific thing, I would find myself often falling down that rabbit.
Yeah, sometimes that does happen to me.
That hole of click.
Hey, you may have ADHD, Venus Theory.
Clicking suggested and recommended things and then kind of forgetting why I was on.
It's 4 a.m, I'm like, oh my God, what did I get on the computer for in the first place?
And this really helped to make that just not happen anymore because it wasn't possible. And finally, number five is when it comes to
might be good to have that on by default, but then remember you want to like, sometimes you do want to turn it on, you know, or turn on recommendations, whatnot.
Devices, question your assumptions, and consume intentionally. An example of this would be, instead of asking yourself what you're going to check Instagram for, ask yourself why you need to actually check it at all. And if you are going to
need a Weaver Beats 3 channel, there's a Weaver Beats Clips channel and a Weaver Beats Beats channel that I don't use really anymore. The Weaver Beats Clips channel, I think I got fucking locked out of though. Like basically YouTube was just like, hey, you're logging in from a different internet now, and we don't think this is you anymore. We sent a code to your phone that you can confirm. We confirm that code that you did send the code back. But we still don't think this is you. So fuck you. And then I haven't tried since then the other day.
do something with one of your devices, always know why you're doing it and what the specific goal is. I guess all that is to say, just remember that your digital tools are just that. They're tools to accomplish a specific task. If you've ever tried painting a wall with a hammer, you would know that you're probably doing it wrong. Even though I am sort of just getting started.
This guy can't paint a wall with a hammer, amateur. Dude, just put the paint on the hammer, then slide the hammer across the wall. Like,
started with my whole digital minimalist journey, I guess, I did want to share just a few things that have really stood out to me so far from this whole experiment.
Yeah, definitely, you can't do it with that attitude.
Just in the last couple weeks. I think the big thing is that if you truly want to change your behavior and habits, you need...
Oh god, this shot right here is so pretentious, dude. I'm sorry, Venus Theory, but this is a little too much here with the... We get the flowers, we get the do the fucking work thing, you're sitting in the corner with the... I don't know, it's too perfect, man.
To control both the metaphorical carrot and stick. If you want to stop eating chips, you just stop buying chips. I've also learned that especially...
Who the hell wants to stop eating chips, dude? Jesus, dude.
Especially when it comes to...
Who wants to stop eating chips?
The real productivity, the idea of multitasking... seems like bullshit.
Yeah, it doesn't work. You just get distracted and get less done.
I guess what I mean by this is if you're changing tasks a lot, and especially if you're
just getting none of those tasks done. I agree with that. I multitask sometimes too, and I'm just like, you know, I'm just doing a shitty job at all of these tasks right now.
Doing the type of task you're doing, and especially if it's a different type of creative task, it's pretty hard to commit to finishing or doing a particularly good job with any one specific thing. In the words of Ron Swanson, don't half-ass two things, whole-ass one thing. Instead, I found it's a lot more...
Same, dude. Instead of making one thing semi, or a bunch of things semi-ass, I make one thing really ass.
Functional to just batch your similar tasks and ideas together, and also try to keep them to a schedule at least as much as reasonably possible. Because of that, I've become a lot better at understanding not only the use of my time, but also my own creative limits and how long I can realistically do some kind of creative work, which has resulted not only in improved focus when it comes to doing creative sessions.
New daily routine, what the fuck?
But also understanding that I do have a limit of-
Let's say shower, sleep, poop. Hold on. Sleep prep, okay. Holy shit, he showers twice or three times a day, twice.
Also, understanding that I do have a limit of only a couple real hours of creativity in me on a given day. Being someone who works from home full-time, this is also especially helpful because it is easy to fall into that trap of working 16-hour days and then realizing you haven't actually accomplished all that much. By also continuing to develop this habit of consuming information and content and books and things more intentionally instead of passively, I find myself more actively and consciously seeking or consuming things that I find truly interesting or inspiring. And really, now that I think about it, maybe the biggest lesson of all was starting to understand that you don't have to fill all of your time all of the time. Sometimes it is okay to be bored, and sometimes it is okay to just do nothing in particular at all. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That's what I wanted to share and what I wanted to talk about in this video, I guess. And I don't know, maybe it's worth ending this one on what might be one of my favorite quotes of all time about just life and the universe and everything from Dima from Battlefield. Well, I guess technically it's Dima quoting Vladimir from Battlefield 3, but whatever. You only get to die once. Make sure it's worth it.
Okay. Interesting quote there. I mean, overall, I think it was a pretty good video. He makes some pretty good points about digital minimalism. Venus is so annoying. How is he annoying? Like, how is he annoying? I don't really understand how would he be annoying. I don't know. The quote is, it's all going to shit. The quote is, I need to take a shit right now. I don't know. He makes some pretty good points, I think. I don't really have much to say about it, to be honest. All right, I guess we're gonna watch something else. Should we watch let's watch the Ben Jordan thing? Battlefield 3, really? Yeah. All right, let's see. Ben Jordan. Oh, is this right here? Bro, he wanted me to react to something in this video, and I don't know, I kind of fucked up by not doing it.
I'm going to do something.
He said maybe you should just react to the video after. I'm like,
That I've never done in my 25-year-old music career.
Should we still press one if we should keep the engagement corner going? Okay, reacting to I Gotta Make a Beat. I Got to Make a Beat for My Favorite Rapper by Ben Jordan. And we have engagement corner right now with, I need to explain this for the We Are Beats 2 video. This is going to be turned into. We have CSGO surfing, Subway Surfers. There's a lot of surfer action going on here. Plus a We Are Beats 2 channel video going on here just to keep people engaged. And it's not, there's nothing wrong with Ben Jordan or his video. We're doing this purely. What's happening out there? We're doing this purely for the people with ADHD.
I'm going to listen to hundreds, actually thousands, of older songs. Then I'm going to flip some samples from those songs. Then I'm going to make a beat. Then I'm going to clear those samples or license them. And then I'm going.
That's expensive.
Going to rap. Just kidding, I will not be rapping in this video at all, I promise.
Oh man, I wish Ben Jordan was rapping in this video.
But I will be giving this beat to one of my favorite rappers, and I might be completely out of my element here. What is the difference between a composer, a producer, and a beat maker? This isn't a joke, it's an actual question. No, guys, according to the AI copilot that I never asked for that exists on my Windows desktop, a composer creates original music compositions.
Yeah, fair.
A producer guides the entire music production process, working closely with artists. Mm-hmm. And a beatmaker specializes in creating instrumental beats, which serve as the backbone of songs. I've never traditionally produced a beat for a rapper. I've made music.
Like, you can be all three things or one individually. You could just be, DJ Khaled.
Music in the tempo of hip-hop.
The video is clipped? What do you mean? Like, I'm clipping it, or?
Which is, like, the whitest thing in the world to say. I have composed music in the tempo of hip-hop. I have fooled around and made beat tapes, but I'd never released them. I have composed original music for a rapper as a ghostwriter, but I have never taken the art of sample flipping seriously until now. Now, don't get me wrong, I highly respect the
art. You don't really even have to flip it. Like, you can if you want to.
To making beats, I take.
Like, sometimes, like, it's just good as it is, too.
Take them very.
Like, it's basically your decision whether or not it should be flipped in a way that sounds different.
Pretty seriously when listening to them. I burn incense at my altar praising J Dilla every morning.
He's been in FL a long time.
Morning, just like everybody else. In fact, I think that the most innovative music in the world right now is hip-hop. And I'm jealous. I want to be a beat producer. I even wanted to make this video for a while, but there are two things that got in my way. Number one, I have worked with sync licensing long enough to know how problematic and potentially catastrophic it can be to flip a sample without clearance. And number two, beat making seems really laid back and chill, and I'm just way too neurotic. Fortunately, there are some more modern solutions to.
I need to make IDM. I am too fucked in the head. I need to make IDM. I need to listen to IDM.
The sync licensing and clearing nightmare, and a lot of beat makers and producers like to use loop libraries like Splice. I personally wanted to go through the process of digging through old songs and repurposing the tracks, and there also seems to be
it is a lot more legit
solution for my neurosis as well. So there's a company called Tracklib that maybe it's pronounced Tracklib. I'm not really sure because I haven't had a conversation in real life in like 10 years, but
it's pretty good.
Tracklib has been around for a few years, and they haven't.
Oh, you're saying the video is cut off? Okay, yeah, you gotta be more specific, bro. When you say the video is cut, when you say it's clipped, I'm like, the audio? You mean the audio is clipped? Okay, let me resize it a little bit. It's still gonna be clipped a little bit, no matter what. But okay, I can probably make it a little smaller. That's probably pretty good. That's about as good as it's gonna get.
Interesting solution to this problem. They've been acquiring rights to redistribute hundreds of thousands of older, mostly obscure songs. Some of them are vinyl rips, and others actually have stems from the masters. By the way, discretion alert, I've spoken to Tracklib.
He's just showing Tracklib for the whole video. Yeah, it was probably like an integrated sponsorship that he planned on doing. I don't know. I mean, that doesn't mean the video's bad, but it kind of like makes the video feel a little hollow.
Directly over email and have a relationship with them, primarily to make sure that I understand what I'm talking about in this video when talking about how the licensing works. In that exchange, they generously offered to sponsor the video. And
is there actually a point of vinyl? It's got the analog warmth, man. Sounds old and shitty, but in a good way.
Gave me a free membership with more credits than I could ever hope to use. And there's also a link in the description where my viewers can get 30 free credits. So if you want to check this out, not bad. So traditionally, the way Tracklib works...
Suno AI or UDO? Suno seemed better to me, but they're both garbage. And they're for garbage people. If you use it, you're garbage.
Worked was you paid a small subscription fee, and then if you chose to use a song, you could then license it for a variable fee, and then you would have to pay a small percentage of royalties to the license owner, usually around 2 to 10%, which you could set up with like DistroKid or TuneCore. Now, more recently, for their Premium and Max members, they launched unlimited sample clearances. So without further ado, let's dig through some virtual record crates on the internet.
I did my part in popular UDO with shitty music. Yeah, we should make lots more music about shit in your pants, you know, and then upload it to UDO or Suno.
So I've just selected jazz in the BPM between 90 and 100, release year between 1928 and 1997, and there's a lot here. Like a lot. Like a lot.
Vibe. It's a vaporwave vibe. The Ben Spotify bot video ended so weird with him shilling his thing as answer to the problem. Yeah, that was kind of weird. Where can I find your music, Weaver? Just literally type in Weaver Beats. Like, I don't understand why people ask that question. Just type in Weaver Beats and then you can find the music.
Ooh.
This bit goes on forever. I'm curious what he's looking at though.
Ooh. Ooh. Set a loop here. We can just use our...
You can set a loop. That's pretty dope.
Arrow keys. And then we could put a beat behind it.
You could put a beat behind it? This is like drum and bass tempo. What is going on? There you go. You got it. Rap beat right there. Hot fire, rip your head off.
Simple rock beat.
I eat tires. Smoke crack.
Oh yeah. WBX 94.4. This is Friday night.
Oh my god.
Baby, I'm gonna sample you.
Please don't. Okay, that's pretty good there. I would have picked this. That was really good. You talking to anything?
No. I just played it at like 7 different jobs.
Nice. I fucking hate lo-fi drum beats like that. So fucking shit. The sample's pretty good though.
That is a dirty record.
I guess it's kind of good they have like the ability to put like drum loops on it, because you can kind of test it before you clear the sample, you know? Sexy. I've subbed the Weaver for some time. I still have no idea what instrument he plays. Keyboard. I can also play guitar very poorly too.
Sexy lady. It's all right.
Ooh. Oh, shit. I'm like in the way. Should we just get rid of the, I kind of want to get rid of the engagement corner, guys. Maybe I'll just put myself up here. So that way it's like, this is crazy because we're like taking up the whole fucking screen right now.
Ooh. Yeah, I really like that loop.
Bro, that one earlier was super good.
I keep falling down these rabbit holes.
What's your sponsor, Weaver? For what?
Of artists. This is Tony Iglio's drugstore. Oh yeah. Tony.
You on top, Ben is on the bottom. Stop it. You stop it. I see what you're doing there. Stop that.
Thank you. I love this. As I'm digging...
My drug sponsor, I don't really know his name, but he supplies me with black tar heroin.
Deeper into what seems to definitely be over 100,000 tracks. I'm running into a lot of musicians that I know. For example, Raskovich is...
Who gives you the Zans? My doctor. I'm not on Zans right now.
a pretty lit.
I only take this as that sort of stuff as prescribed. All right, I'm not a drug abuser. I don't believe in abusing drugs.
Legendary library.
I believe in abusing people who use drugs.
Composer from the 70s. His stuff is super experimental and avant-garde, and I feel like there has to be some sort of catch to it. Like, now I can just sample and release it.
Yeah, drugs are for losers. If you've ever used drugs once or thought about it, you're a loser. What hardware instrument did you bring to Hawaii? I've lived here my whole life.
Prove to you that I'm not pulling your train.
We need First in the Morning pre-Zan Weaver. What the fuck, dude? You're always getting pre-Zan Weaver. What are you talking about?
In here, here's my massive MP3 collection, and one of the biggest folders in it is my library music collection.
Dr. Roxham disagrees with what?
And that has everything.
Engagement Corner, let's go. Yeah. Yo, you better get Weaver Beats 2 on here, bro.
Thing sort of organized with the companies or the libraries that release them. So there's KPM, that's an absolutely massive one. Bruton's a big one. Then there's some smaller ones like Barry. Color Sound is amazing. And so most of these were vinyl
records. The Engagement Corner, I'm late. Fucking ADHD, dude. What do you think? So you're having the Xan at some point in the future? No, I don't take Xanax. Like, I only take it if I'm having like a panic attack. I don't abuse drugs.
And they would chip these.
The only drugs I've done today are caffeine. Copious amounts of caffeine. All right, I have soda here and I have fucking coffee. You know what? We're switching to coffee. If Venusaur did fentanyl maxing, he'd become the next big rapper out of Atlanta. I need to see that.
Vinyl records to, I don't know, NBC or CBS or something. And then if NBC or CBS wanted...
Starbucks chill. This is actually... I haven't been using this. I did not... Like, I bought Starbucks, like, a few days ago, and I've just been reusing the cup with cold brew. That's, actually, it was 1 day ago. I bought it 1 day ago. 2 days ago would be kind of meh. But, yeah, I'm using it as a cup for cold brew that is in the fridge. And I have some French toast syrup.
To use one of the songs in one of the shows, and they would have to pay a license fee. So the Renaissance period of library music would be like the late 60s.
Okay, this is boring. This part's starting to bore me. I'm gonna skip ahead of it.
As the perfect thing to be sampled in another genre, which is interesting and probably going to be the subject of a future video of mine, because I would love to see how all of this stuff is produced.
I am salty I didn't appear to react to this in the video. Wait, did... Hold on. Is there... dude. Man. I could have been in this video.
So I basically went over...
French toast syrup? No, I mean, like, literally, like, French toast flavoring for the coffee. Like, they sell that. I saw it earlier today. That's some Asmin Gold Cup. It's not. It's been 1 day, bro. They were selling it earlier at Ross, and I was just like, that sounds interesting. I'll try that.
Board and picked out and downloaded close to 100 songs, and despite being able to mark and download loops automatically from TrackLib, I wanted to do things my way and surgically pull them out of tracks in a way that would be perfect or imperfect in time and avoid any pops. If you're as anal retentive or insufferable as I am and you're curious about how to do this, it's actually not that difficult. You can use Audacity. I use Adobe Audition. You zoom in all the way to the microsecond scale and you find a zero crossing, or where the waveform is in the center of the display.
Yeah.
These are your loop points. No more clicks or pops, it's smooth. Anyway, unsurprisingly, I went overboard here too, and I made over 50 different loops, and that was the moment.
Bro, what?
Moment when I realized that I'm doing precisely what I said I wouldn't do with this project.
Starbucks and Coke. I'm not doing fucking Coke, dude. That is a good way to get panic attacks. That's a good way to have fucking heart palpitations and potentially die.
Project being my neurotic self. So I hit the decks. Is that a phrase that anybody uses?
50 loops? That's insane. Just make one good one that someone could rap over. And if they don't like that, then try again.
Is this to describe going to work on turntables? I mean, it sounds like it is. It should be if...
in the decks.
Believe it or not, I am incredibly comfortable using a DJ kit. Once upon a time, back in the day, for years, I had a weekly DJ residency in Chicago, which was both a lot of fun, but also helped me make ends meet in my early days as a musician.
You should do Starbucks, Coke, and then Xanax. It'll cancel everything out, and you'll achieve true analog warmth. No, I think your heart's going to explode. You're just giving your body, like, contradicting signals.
Now more recently,
I think like some constant hi-hats and that right there could work.
I previously used the standalone Denon Prime system as my stem player for performing.
You're not going to peer pressure me to do shit, man. I got rent to pay.
Flashbulb, and despite it being frustrating with forcing its terrible BPM detection on you, it is an incredibly fun way to flip samples.
I don't know. I don't like flipping samples with a DJ controller or whatever the fuck that is. But what I would do is just rip these songs off a track lib and then figure out what I'm going to make. Like what I actually, like maybe try to make a few different beats. And then figure out which one the rapper is going to use and then clear it. Once it's all done. Clear it once it's all done. That's why you buy the same thing when you buy a beat from a producer. You buy it once it's all done. You don't buy it thinking, well, this could be good. I could think I can do something good with this. Because what if it doesn't work out? Oh, he does that? I missed that part.
Okay. I think this is going to be the one. So Superlative, the rapper I'm producing for here, sent me...
Oh, he has him reacting to it, right? Oh, he doesn't have anyone else reacting. Okay. It looks like it.
His vocals, and yeah, they're pretty much top-notch, and I have very little room for error here, as I have very little experience in this genre, and somebody else's valuable time and energy is relying on me to not completely shit myself like a jazz IDM dork overreaching into hip-hop, which I'm probably...
Bro...
So I dragged
the headphones of those K240 or something. I don't know.
Vocals into FL Studio, and I tried out a lot of different ideas.
Mindset, time spent, lots of inquisitive days I've spent. Widespread, taking it gold from the page I've been writing. Get your marks and the scars limitless, but each day looking like I could be safe living it.
It depends on the style of the person.
It's not Mbappe the toaster.
I ultimately landed on a similar combo.
I hate the hi-hat on that beat.
Bow I cut at the turntables, and I finally started feeling a bit of confidence once I added enough layers to make it sound huge.
Is he a UK rapper? Gotta give him some drill beats then, or some grime. Oh my god, I want to hear the finished beat.
Depressing to sounding... So after a bit of experimenting and trial and error with mixing and mastering, I think I'm ready to send this off.
Yes, yes, people. My name is Superlative. The time is 9 a.m. and I've just been sent through the new song by Ben. And I'm going to check this out now live for you guys. So let's get into it.
Master of procrastination and soul black. Now more than ever, my niggas can take the throne.
Jazzy.
Back. Still ligature marks and the scars limitless, but each day looking like I could be safe living.
Woo!
Boom bap, it's not Mbappe, the toes tap. Still.
So wait, I'm confused. Did he just slap an acapella on it?
Straight passing up bad vibes.
Smooth,
bad
man.
Vibes will stay damaging. Assault games till they see these no longer read. Please, they panicking. Stay quiet. If you ain't here for the struggle, I make a wage right there from the.
You know, this guy's dope.
Years that my neighbor's been hearing too.
Did he just slap an acapella on this? I'm like confused.
Track. Upgrade the speakers and mom is telling me move.
That's.
All kinds of peekery sneaks decent, but the.
Or did he already record it? I'm confused because he's reacting as if he hasn't heard it before. I'm really confused right now.
Low, loads of them pre in the EP. Boy. No VC, pay what they please. These were stacking.
Yeah.
Real G's, get out the streets, see what's happening.
Ah, making minds out of molehills.
I click my fingers.
But he knows the lyrics. I'm really confused, dude. Someone explain to me what's happening. He sent the vocals, I think.
Deliver lyrics and soul.
Boy.
To grow, know what I already know is dope. Dome holes, infinite possibility mindset.
Time
spent, lots of inquisitive days I've spent. Widespread, taking and going.
I don't know, this is fire to me.
On the page I've been writing, feeling like days become years fast. Now they stay gas, gather the masses.
Your boys rap it. Oh, that is fire. I'm gonna play that one more time.
I usually like grime music though. If I'm hearing a UK rapper, I want to hear grime. Like, I don't really want to hear a UK rapper on like a US sounding beat.
I love that when the synth opens up and becomes like, it's like super reverberated, but all of a sudden it's like your mind feels clarity.
Yeah, Ben killed it. I kind of wish there was a little more swing on the drums.
I love.
What about grimes? Grime, like the genre, like grime the genre, like, you know, like Skepta or something, or Jamie.
Love that, man. I love that. Ben, you killed this one.
I am elated. Thank you.
I feel like usually you want more swing with that sort of sound.
Don't think that I'm going to become the next Dre here, but once I stopped doubting myself, I kind of just went with the flow and I got the dopamine rush I was looking for. When listening to J Dilla, part of me always,
well, why is you don't like my tune?
Imagined him just,
yeah, Dizzy Rascal, it's known.
Powering on his MPC 3000 and tapping out like 50.
Yeah, hit the like button if you guys haven't, please.
15 legendary beats a day while barely even paying attention. But that would be totally wrong. He not only learned and played the drums and other various instruments on his tracks himself, but if you dissect his recordings, the amount of deep digging and raw creativity to find his samples and sound sources is nothing short of phenomenal. In fact, there's a strong argument that J Dilla was a jazz innovator, and Kareem Riggins one of the best.
I think it's a waste of sample clearance. I mean, I feel like, well, I like some, I've done anything for 3 years. I'm pretty sure they help. Like, it decides some of that based off of whether or not people like it. Like, it recommends it more. But also, it fights against dislikes when people dislike. Let's see. I think it's a waste of sample clearance. I mean, the thing is, you're getting the inspiration from it. Like, you know, he probably wouldn't have thought to do this exact idea either. You could just replace it yourself by playing it, though. And, you know, it'd be easier to have less things to clear.
Jazz Drummers Alive and sax player Greg Osby attribute Dilla's style to changing the land.
I told you J Dilla would be mentioned. But I saw this video that was talking about like swing, and this guy was like, who's that guy that everyone talks about, like J Dilla or something? I was just like, oh my god, dude. I'm surprised they weren't murdering him in the comments. I think it was because he had like 100 subs.
Landscape of jazz and freeing it from this.
What am I looking at? This is stupid. Sounds like shit.
Takeaway from this, I think that I was initially incredibly wrong. I can't
Rick be Beato for sure. Never heard of J Dilla. We should look it up. I'm curious now.
Sure, but maybe beat making is not chill after all. Maybe those who are great at it are probably perfectionists and incredibly neurotic, but they possess the ability of making it look easy. What do you think? How did I do? There's a comment.
I think he did pretty good, but I think more swing would have been good on the beat.
Box below, let me know. I want to thank Tracklib for the absolute torrent.
Okay, we got it. Thank you for watching this video. We're not over with the stream yet, guys. I'm just kind of prefacing because it's gonna be a Weird Beats 2 video for sure. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Bless you. Sorry, my girlfriend was sneezing. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Check out my stream if you haven't. Anyways, okay, we're going to continue on to the next thing here, guys. Just wanted to
end of music.
Put that for the video. Rick Beato, J Dilla. Let's see. You think he knows who he is? He does. Okay, he's never done a video on him. He's never done a video on J Dilla. Ugh, shameful. What's the conclusion on this video? Domestic abuse situation about to go on. You saw a look in his eyes. Nah, I was just looking. How's the grift going, Weaver? There's no grift, all right? But give me fucking money. Why are you not giving? I'm just kidding. we like to have fun here. We like to have fun here. I'm his neighbor. I can hear them through the walls. I just moved in here. But yeah, Rick Beato has no J Dilla video. That's interesting. I would think he would have a J Dilla video. Does he even know who they are? Or who he is, sorry. Have a look at the Bad Gear, the new one. No Grift, Just Give. All right, let's see. This kind of looks interesting. I think this is clickbait. It's the Cosmic Academy. It's for sure clickbait. This is the guy that did that fucking, the one with the weird voiceover. Bro, you got to make an explainer read on how Dilla inspired Trap, or I don't know. Is that Diddy? Diddy? I don't know. I'm rich. Will no one take pity on me and send me more money? I'm not rich. Talking about me. Rick Beato has a video of mixing old vinyls in his decks. That's interesting. Okay, maybe we'll do the Bad Gear. I'm not clicking on this Cosmic Academy video. This is going to be some bullshit. I've seen his videos before. They're bullshit. Is this the Bad Gear video you're talking about? Hold on, let me look. What's talking about me? I don't know about Dilla. It seems like the move recently. Beato did a Dilla video 4 years ago, how sampling changed modern drumming. Okay, I didn't know about that. I was curious if you knew about them. Let's see. Okay, yeah, this is one from 5 days ago. I always feel like I don't have a lot to say in most Bad Gear videos because I don't have the gear that he's talking about, you know? That's one reason I'm kind of like, I don't know if I should react to him, you know? See, we'll figure out the next thing we're doing in a second here. Something about throw your Digitech away. I think that's an older one. 1 second here. Let's see. Okay, let's move on to the next thing here. Want a Hydrosynth? Yeah, I played with the Hydrosynth before. It's pretty good. Let's see. What are you guys saying here? Get on that puppet level, boy. What are you talking about puppet level? Are you talking about Reed Stefan? We're talking about grifting here? Talking about get on that grift level? Hold on, let me just check my DMs real quick. Okay. Even the desktop version with the little pads. I'm doing a Venus theory style video on how Dilla taught me to live unquantized. Well, it just makes it sound more realistic, you know? It makes your drum sound realistic. Reed Stefan? Okay. I wasn't sure what you're saying. Dick Beato is a porn star in another universe. Interesting. Let me see if there's any other things we should check out right now before we go into Bad Gear. It's like a last minute. That's a last minute decision there. We're going to do Bad Gear. All right, let me move this. What is this in the background here? What is this? Is it this? Okay, fixed it. Let's see. Dick Beato, how the Astrolab. They have Astrolab. Let's see. Okay, I guess we're gonna do Bad Gear. All right, get ready, guys. Bad Gear, a new foe has appeared. All right. You search the subtitles for every Rick Beato video, no Dilla mentions. Bro, how do you... It must have taken a lot of time. Okay, we're turning off the engagement corner, guys. We can't have engagement corner in every video, all right? Now, if I really wanted to grift right now, I'd be like, okay, hey, donate $20 and I'll bring back the engagement corner. But I'm not doing it, okay? I'm not doing that, okay? I don't care if you donate $20. I'm not bringing back the engagement corner, okay?
Hey, Busy.
What was that? Hey, thank you for the tier one sub, Bo Diddley. Appreciate that, man. Subscribe for 31 months, dude. I appreciate that. That's huge. I was so engaged. I don't care what you do. We're not bringing back the engagement corner, all right? It's just disrespectful. I was fine with disrespecting Venus Theory and maybe even Ben. I am kind of scared that they're going to hurt me. I can't have more enemies at this point, all right? Let's see. Okay, moving on. Okay, Bad Gear.
Welcome to Bad Gear, the show about...
What are all these books here? Kafka... I don't know what's going on here. Oh, there's videos here too. Or, sorry, movies. City of God. I don't really recognize any of these books. Shakespeare, The Complete Works. Do you think he really reads these? Do you think he just, like, got a bunch of books
from, Busy.
Like... Whoa. You think he just got a bunch of books from, like... I don't know, the library? And then he's just... You know, trying to look like, hey, like, I'm a smart guy. I got a lot going on here. I'm not just some gear nerd. Holy shit. Hey, yo. Yo. Dude, thank you for the gifted tier subs, Bo Dilly. Appreciate that. 5 tier 1 subs. I wouldn't fuck with bad gear, dude, either. Yeah, dude. You never know, dude. Appreciate that for real, man. That was huge. That's scary, dude. Some people just own books to show off that they read. Either that or, you know, or they buy them to look like they read. Either that, one of those two. It's cool. Thank you, Bodhi. Appreciate that, man. You're the shit. Yeah, I need the air horns. Nah, I don't have that ready to go, I don't think. Let me see if I got, I got that. And I got a fart sound effect. I don't think I got, don't quite have an air horn. Maybe I should get down next. Nice grift. Bro, I'm not grifting, okay? I'm not grifting. You want to see grift? You don't want to see grift, man. I could grift, all right? This is not a grift. All right, let's see. Smash or pass, read Stefan GF. Dude, you're trying to get me in trouble, dude. You're trying to get me in trouble. Stop it, all right? Stop it. I'm not saying anything. I'm not saying anything. All right, okay. Anyways, do you guys, I need to ask him. Maybe we'll find out in the video when this becomes a Weird Beats 2 video.
The world's most hated art.
Because he responds every single time I post a reaction of it.
Audio tools. Synthesizers can be considered a mature technology. Traditional manufacturers focus on the regurgitation of...
Okay, we could design a brand new analog gear. I said only digital overpriced remakes. I feel like that's like every fucking synth company, right? Or almost all of them.
Classics.
He could be recording at the library too. That is true.
Markets.
For all we know, we don't really know. He could be.
Disruption is limited to design overkill and process optimization, and real innovators are crushed by the relentless.
Your mutable instruments, right? Yeah, we're going to use your code in our new synthesizer. There's no money involved, but it'll get you lots of exposure. Oh, cool. Speaking of exposure, it's not really a good joke.
The economics of this oversaturated niche. Today,
most of his books are DVDs. The bottom left corner is all DVDs for sure. I want to read, you can't really read them. I want to know what they are, though. I want to know more about this elusive man.
We are going to talk about Hydrosynth. This range of next.
Oh, shit. Hey. Hydrosynth.
Generation synthesizers cost a hype that usually only comes with the release of Scandinavian hipster gadgets. And depending on whom you ask, they're either the CS80 of the...
Okay, when you successfully acquired a real vintage CS80 after selling your wife's kidney... Bro, if you're selling your wife's kidney, are you telling her about it? Or like, are you just sneaking it while she's asleep? Or like, I'm not sure how you're going to sneak that, but...
20...
Hey, babe, can I sell your kidney for a synthesizer?
No. What the fuck?
She said yes, guys.
20s are a harsh and digital-sounding testament.
Ah, wait, I missed it. Oh, that's just AI-generated. That's kind of fire, though.
...meant to the demise of a culture.
At the first glance, Hydrosynths are ticking all the VST-in-a-box boxes.
She said yes. Yeah, she said yes, guys.
I opted...
She said yes.
...for the Explorer version... Because A, it's easier to film, B, they all sound the same, and C, I can't play keyboards anyways. Even this gateway drug.
Facts.
Drug among Hydras comes with shadily patented polyphonic aftertouch.
Hey guys, what should I do with that money, dude? I'm wondering if Badger figured out an algorithmic shit where if you make the viewers have to pause for every damn second, it's more engagement. Well, the thing is, like, watch time is huge, and I think, by having more shit on the screen, you're just increasing the watch time overall. I don't know if the pausing has any effect on it. They might be replaying it too. That could be it also.
But you will have to make do with a smaller display and reduced number of adult-sized knobs. But more of that later. The synth engine offers 8 voices of...
Yeah, probably gaming the rewind.
...of polyphony... ...and is based on so-called waveform scanning oscillators. Classic VA.
Engagement corner, more shit on the screen, more watch time, yeah. Yeah, maybe we should bring back the engagement corner, I don't know. Actually, doesn't sound like a bad idea.
Shapes. accompanied by a rich selection.
I like how he names his patch subscribe. I didn't notice that. That's genius.
Of digital monstrosities for every occasion. The aforementioned.
I mean, pitch that down a couple octaves. You might have a good bass there.
Mentioned scanning technology can be found in two of the three oscillators and is a simplified wavetable feature with wavelength.
Like, some of the jokes are like, so, like, what? Like, what was this? What was that in reference to? What was that?
Simplified wavetable.
Wavetable. This is what we get for wavetable. What is this? What is this? Is that a table underneath the water?
Table feature with wave list of
Bronx. You say everything is a grift. Like, this is a grift. I'm grifting. You're grifting. Chat's grifting.
Of up to 8 slots.
My girlfriend's grifting right now. They're waving on a table. It's to get you to stop, rewind several times. Upload video speed 2x. Viewers have to watch it at 0.5x. Game the algorithm.
These oscillators are embedded in a somewhat traditional synth structure.
I don't get that one. I don't get this one, but I don't really get this meme, like this format. Is this a serial killer or something? I don't know. I don't really understand this meme.
Should depicted on the front panel. This
Oh god, I'm glad he didn't finish that riff.
Diff signal flow chart lets you access its most essential building blocks and gives you a glimpse into the sound design facilities that make the synth unique. In addition to the ring modulation. Noise section.
I'm grifting so hard right now, dude. I'm about to grift so hard right now.
You will find 4 mutators allowing for 2 operate.
It's a musician, it's an album cover where he's sad and happy.
FM wave stacking for super saw like waveforms. Sing.
Wait, is Bad Gear German? He is, right? Wait, that reminds me of this. Hold on a second. Is it this one?
Wow, what a twist.
Right here.
The first annual comedy.
This is Bad Gear right here. this is what watching a Bad Gear video is.
The first
Austrian? Austrian's not German, right? I don't know, he reminds me of a German dude for some reason. Well, either way, I'm still gonna make this joke here.
Annual Comedy Awards.
This is what Bad Gear reminds me of.
Were held by the school children yesterday, and all of
Germany. I remember saying he's German too. I think that's funnier to me.
Germany is outraged. Yeah. Deutschland ist ein Land aus Stotluten. Und wir werden nicht dies belängt nehmen. Der Comedy Award in Wala haben sie jam afflict. Der Comedy Award in Wala sind falsch. Ich mag der Wert abisch, da wir Deutsch sehr lustig sind. Wir machen die Witzler im Büro und zu Hause. Ich werde jetzt Deutsch Witz sagen. Und Wutschmacher kauft.
I could have sworn this part was in English in the fucking show.
Ein Muschli Box. Ich werde jetzt not ander Witz sagen. Nachwest. Wer ist das? Ein Kannibal. Was?
What?
Du bist etwa zu sterben und gegessen werden. Schweinhund, ich werde ihn nicht umbringen.
Do bits give you money, Weaver? Yeah, they do. I'm not sure how much. I think like, what is it? Like $1 for $100 or something? Something like that. I don't know what it is. I'm not pulling a Kanye right now. But yeah, the humor is kind of similar. It's just like really fucking dry. Is there another one here? Wait, hold on.
Is it true? The Germans want to kill us? Yeah.
What if his memes are like cutting edge in Germany? True.
The Jimmy. Now,
oh, let me skip ahead.
Es war Kinder der Special Education. Sie macht uns wählen.
Wollen Sie endlich.
Why is this too quiet?
Dürfen wir der Kind dort geboten.
Okay, never mind. Oh my god, it's fucking pointing to Kyle. Oh my fucking god. Oh god, dude. Okay, let's see. Where is it?
Three types of PWM. A phase shifter.
I want to just donate, but it made me buy annoying bits. Another way to is super chatting on YouTube.
And the harmonic mutator, I've yet to fully understand.
Yeah, I don't fully understand this either. I feel like he could do a better job showing patches that he makes in these videos. Like, some of these patches he's shown would have sound better at, like, a, you know, a lower octave or, like, a different note or something.
The raw tone.
Yeah, I really like the waveform visualization on this synth. This is pretty dope.
The raw tones are shaped further by two filters, which can be operated in serial and parallel mode. Filter 1 lets you select bread and butter models.
I don't even know what super chat is. It's like a way to, like, I don't know, it gives me money and then it, like, you get to put a message with it or some shit. I don't know. Oh, hey, thank you for the bits, Cade. Holy shit. Wait, how many was that? 100, 1,000, another 1,000. Holy shit. Yo, thank you for all those bits, dude. I appreciate that, Cade. For real. Appreciate that, man. It's huge. Let's see. You know, since it didn't do the sound effect.
Hey, busy.
Crack money, bro. I don't do fucking crack. I do heroin. Super chat keeps like 60%. Yeah, that's true. You could use stream elements also. I think I get like 100% of that. I think I have it in the description on YouTube, but I don't know. I don't really care. All that stuff I appreciate, guys. It's just it helps. It helps, you know. It does not hurt. All right, back to this.
With drive.
Crack with Av, though. The only time I'll ever do crack is with Av McCree, all right, at NAMM. But NAMM just passed, and...
Number two is...
I have stream elements. It's in the description. Should be.
Morphable between a 12...
I would also do crack with BWB. I don't think he's willing to do crack, though. Hold on a second. Okay. You pick the wrong grift. Musicians have no money, dummy. True, true.
50 dB high, band, and low pass. 5 overpowered LFOs. And envelopes not only modulate staples like amplitude and filter cutoff, they also can, together with the awesome performance controllers of the top shelf models, be freely routed using a 32 slot modulation matrix.
Man, we'll be back next year. No fuck. Wow. Holy shit. Okay, well, that's news. I didn't know about that. How long until the FBI find you in your new place, too? Hopefully not very long. Wait, no. Hopefully very long. I don't want them to find me.
Macros assist.
Guys, donate money, okay? I need to stay on the run from the FBI, all right? It's up to you guys.
Is you in control?
I'm just kidding, obviously.
Controlling the abundance of parameters.
That's pretty cool. Hey, Ben Jordan would love this thing.
All this is topped off with a truly epic sounding FX section, a multi FX unit.
Hydrosynths are kind of cool.
With each before and after reverb and delay.
I have much more expensive synths that do a lot less, yeah.
Nice. You can work around the instrument's complexity with a convenient randomization feature and non-keyboard players like...
Wait, there's a randomized function on it? Hold on. Okay. Particularly craft a patch precisely to your needs. Use randomize to get a usable sound. Wait, you can randomize on it?
Randomization.
That's kind of awesome.
...feature and non-keyboard players like me will appreciate the chord functionality... and roided up.
Had one for 2 years and still pulled new sounds out of it. That's awesome.
Arpeggiator.
Is it randomized? Okay, that's awesome. don't know, if I buy a synth, I might have to get one of these. I don't know about this one in particular, but a Hydra synth.
The synth is Eurorack friendly and rose to social media fame mainly due to its super...
Oh my god, guys, Shia LaBeouf's here. Awesome. Dude, I love your... He will not find us thing. I love that. That was awesome.
Cinematic.
Do that more. Do it again.
Pads.
Everything should have a randomized button.
And ambient sounds. As mentioned before, Hydrosynths come in four different flavors: Keyboard, Desktop, Explorer, and Deluxe, the latter being the only variety with a polyphony.
I mean, the Desktop is cool and all, but like, man, I don't know, it just kind of, it takes away the, like, the coolness of it, you know? Like, you'd rather have, like, an analog, well, a hardware synth, I shouldn't say analog synth, a hardware synth, where it's all together, you know? It's kind of not as cool when you have just the module and then you're using a MIDI keyboard. It really just feels like you're using a fucking computer at that point.
The count of 16 and by timbrality.
Shake that gat, you're getting rained on for real. I don't get notifications from, oh, shit. Yo, holy shit. Yo, thank you for the bits, Bo Diddley. Appreciate that, man. Sorry, I don't get a notification for the bits. 2,000, 5,000, 7,000, 9,000. Yo, thank you, guys. Yo, thank you. I appreciate that, man.
Hey, Busy.
Yeah. Appreciate all that, guys. Means a lot. What's your best skate trick you've ever done? I think I've done, like, a nollie shove, no slide. Shove it, no slide. I think that's probably the best thing I've ever done. Let's see. Okay. Close to a new record in bits. Yeah, that's crazy, dude. Appreciate that, man. Seriously. Okay, let's get back to the vid.
Based on the same synth engine, they mostly differ in size, keyboard implementation, connectivity.
Yeah, basically, part of the reason I don't really ever get hardware synthesizers is just because I don't usually have room. I might be able to make room here. Or I could, like, switch out things, like, and just put something in the closet when I'm not using it. What's the biggest donation you ever got? Probably $100. I don't know if I've gotten anything more than $100. I've gotten a few hundreds before, though. Today, I couldn't even ollie, and the other night, I slipped out on a nose slide. Yeah, I haven't really been skating lately, but, like, in the new area I'm at, there's actually a couple different skate parks near me, so I'm pretty stoked on that. And I actually like the skate parks in this area.
And UI.
They're actually different from the one that I used to skate out all the time.
Awesomeness with the ribbon controller being reserved for the keyboard and deluxe version. In light of all this sci-fi synth goodness, you might want to keep in mind that the underlying technology is slightly overwhelmed by what's going on. The internal preset browser tends to lag when scrolling fast, saving patches will silence your synth for a brief moment, and I've yet to find a way to seamlessly switch between patches. Build quality is good with a
oh man, that's the thing about modular, man. Imagine switching patches on modular. Oh my god, dude, just being like, well, time to set up the other patch. I have a drawing of it. I'm gonna recreate it. It's gonna take me, like, you know, 30 minutes to unplug all these and plug them in the other way, and then you realize, like, ah, fuck, I gotta record that one note again. I didn't take a picture of that one. Oh, shit. Fuck.
Patches. Build quality is good with a few quite obvious compromises. Especially the Little Explorer is competitively priced, and thanks to my dear friend Dominic for lending me the centerpiece of his setup.
ASM Hydrosynths were among the most spectacular market entries in recent years. Are they true game changers, or is it yet another...
Yo, thank you for the even more bits, Bo Diddley. Jesus Christ, dude. Like another 6,000 there. Yo, man, give it up. Bo Diddley's carrying. Also, hey, appreciate that, guys. It's huge. I'm going to do another video tonight. I haven't decided if I'm going to do a WNN or talk about the diss track stuff. I've been meaning to do a video on it. Just buy the synth again, obviously. You might as well just have multiple of them at that point. No problem, you deserve it. Thank you, man.
G.
Appreciate that.
You have already heard the Little Hydra in today's intro tune. I couldn't find a bass preset.
Produce great content. Appreciate that, man. I try.
Really liked, so I made my own. Let's see if there's more where that came from.
Bro, I want to know what kind of gear Bad Gear has. Like, he must be pretty stacked. I know he borrows a lot of this, but he doesn't borrow all of it because he's often using a combination of things in these. I assume you probably sample modular things, like just record all the audio constantly. He buys it and sells it or gives some of it away. I think he also borrows it too, from what I remember. Busy Works Beats wants to learn to grift like me. Bro, he already has like a really good grift. Like, I need to learn how to grift from him, man. With those courses and shit and making plugins that don't work. Making plugins that YouTube declares as a scam. I need to learn from him, man. Because, like, unironically, YouTube actually, like, when I reviewed his Hermes plugin, they actually made me remove the link from the description because they were like, yeah, this is a scam. You cannot link to scams in the description. Like, no fucking joke. They actually made me remove it. A how to find a wife video. I should make like a 10 second how to find a wife video, and it's just like mail order bride. Like, it's just like a YouTube short. It's like mail order bride, just get a mail order bride. That's how you do it.
I like that a lot. Smooth pad sounds aside, I enjoyed the elegant heft of the bass tone, which required me to take a deep dive into the envelope settings on a quest for the lost punch. Hydrosynths are widely known for modern high-end patches and
come to find a wife, get the fuck off YouTube. That's how you find a wife, get the fuck off YouTube.
Like sound design experiments. Time to explore wavetable and FM features and set the arpeggiator to autopilot.
Posted a shot of my studio so far in my new apartment. Nice. I posted one in the Discord. It's in Rate My Studio. Oh, we need to do Rate Your Studio again. Maybe not tonight, but maybe in the next stream, we'll do Rate Your Studio. We need to do Rate Your Studio again. That's always fun. Something different, too. No, Kyle White, you don't want to do that. I'm going to make a VST that plays YouTube videos inside the DAW. No, dude, you missed the Vinyl Theory video earlier. Do not do that. Okay, you're being sarcastic. All right. Do not do that, though. That's literally the opposite of what we were talking about earlier with all the fucking digital minimalism and shit. Be the point of that plugin, you know, or I mean, I guess you could get inspiration, you know, you can get inspiration when you're, you know, making music. I need some inspiration, you know what I mean? and then a way to just extract audio from whatever you're watching in the VST. I mean, that could be awesome actually, but I feel like it's just going to be used for all the wrong purposes. Essentially, it's going to be called Procrastinator. That's actually a good idea for a plugin. How can we break into the plug puppet's house? Bro, I already talked about this before. You gotta become a cat. Become a cat, and then you can get into Reed Stefan's house, okay? They love cats over there. His wife will kill us. I'm pretty sure his wife will kill me, for sure. What's my favorite site to download pirate software? I don't know. I will just say it is Russian. It is Russian, all right? Take a quick look at that photo and tell me what else I need besides succulents. I can make that before the stream is over. You should make it, dude. You should make it. I will review it. Maybe kind of ironically. I will review it ironically. I'll be like, this is the greatest VST of all time. And it's just me watching like fucking Cat Dog or something in my DAW and eating popcorn. I'm like, oh dude, I can multitask so hard right now. Do not use Pirate Bay. All right. That's Pirate Bay has been compromised for a very long time.
Interest.
interesting. I found it challenging to keep the synth out of aggressively digital and harsh sounding territory, especially with some of the more eccentric waveforms and intense use of FM. The arpeggiator is truly awesome. It is not always easy to hit the oftentimes narrow sweet spot of the synth engine in a jam situation. I wanna know if we can isolate some sonic jams in. It's surprising how little it takes when you crank that sweet reverb futuristic.
Okay, I think we get the idea of the video. Let's see. I guess the verdict. We'll skip to the verdict.
Verdict. There's a reason why hydrosynths have become the gold.
That'd be funny. I should tweet that out to Ben Jordan and be like, hey, Ben. This is strictly off the record, but I'm going to tag him. I'm going to put the period in front so everyone can see it. I'm going to be like, hey, Ben, this is strictly off the record here, but do you pirate software? Should I do that? If I tweet that, will you guys go and like and retweet it? This is strictly off the record, so you know, don't worry about it. All right, this is strictly off the record here. Press one if I should do that. I should just do that to like different influencers on different days. Like, I'll do that to Ben today, and then I'll do that to Venus here like tomorrow. Hey, Ben Jordan. Hey. Hey, wait, I don't need the period if I'm being like, hey, Ben Jordan, do you pirate music software? This is strictly off the record. What else should I write, guys? This is 100% strictly off the record. He already said he does, dude. Well, I don't fucking care. This is funny. This is funny to me. Old news. Hugs and kisses. Jerry, hugs and kisses. Yeah, hugs and kisses. XOXO. Asking for a friend. Don't worry. This is strictly off the record. This is such a loaded tweet. This is funny as fuck. So it's such a loaded tweet because it's like, okay, you're writing this in a way that everyone can see it. Oh, let me fix this. You're writing in a way that everyone can see it, and you tagged them. And then you're writing asking for a friend. Then you're writing, don't worry, this is 100% strictly off the record. Then you're writing hugs and kisses XOXO. Oh my god. Alright, send it. I'm gonna send the same tweet to like Venus Siri tomorrow or next time I stream. I'm just gonna like randomly be doing this just to different music influencers, just to, I don't know, it's just funny. It's funny. Okay, I think we're done with bad gear here. Maybe we'll do one more thing real quick. Oh shit, just show my DMs with the dog. Oh shit, I just doxed Tim. I'm sorry, Tim. Do it to BWB and start a war. That's actually pretty good. Okay, I'll do BWB next. You guys gotta remind me though. All right, hold on. Let me just see if there's anything good to watch in the channel. Join the Discord if you haven't, guys. We do lots of fun. We do have lots of fun here. We like to have fun here. Sell your Digitact. I don't want to do another bad gear right now. Let me see if there's anything else here. Don't know what this is. Content suggestions. Blee ass. I always thought Blee ass was funny. Okay, it's apparently OTT with a lot more features. Let's check this out. I need more people giving me content suggestions. Just join the Discord. Yes, I remember. Careful streaming Twitter. I know. I remember what happened last time. That was fucked. Okay, so Blee Ass has a multi-band compressor with not my favorite looking UI. Let's check it out here.
PC.
Oh, he linked it. He linked it at the time where it's like over, basically.
Welcome.
Okay, here we go.
To this video guide about Blee's multi.
I don't know why we're doing a tutorial on it. It is only 2 minutes though.
Bone compressor and its capability.
That'd be pretty funny. Tag Rick Beato and then be like, hey, I heard you use a cracked Pro Tools. Is this true? I'm gonna report on this if you don't answer. I'll give you 24 hours.
Is. The core idea of a multiband compressor is to divide the input sound in distinct frequency band and
I mean basically any multiband compressor could be OTT. You know, you just crank the input and output really hard.
Apply compression to each band independently. In Blee's multiband compressor, the audio signal.
What are you?
Chocolate.
Oh, okay.
Well, let's divide.
I didn't forget to get ice cream.
I forgot.
I didn't forget to get ice cream. Yeah, I forgot to get ice cream because I didn't want to spend more money.
Didn't do it.
We need it.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, right. We need it.
Three frequency bands, which you can customize in this.
Guys, do you guys need ice cream? The crack did not arrive. Okay, that's my girlfriend. The crack did not arrive, all right? An anonymous
section.
Right, I should say that. An anonymous source has informed me. Mint chocolate chip? No. Good God, no. Good, not mint chocolate chip. That's disgusting. Cookie dough. And what else is good? Something with peanut butter. Peanut butter cup. Yeah, that's good too. Content suggestion, how to figure out the half or double the speed of the BPM when DJing. That's pretty good. Cookie dough is goated, dude. Like, for real. Black cherry, green ice cream. What do you mean green ice cream? Like mint flavor? Like, what? Green ice cream? Do you just go to Baskin Robbins asking for green ice cream? Dude, I had a shake from Baskin Robbins yesterday with, like, cookie dough. And I think it was, like, peanut, like, Reese's peanut butter cup or some shit combined in a shake. Dude, that was crazy. I only treated myself because we were moving yesterday and we like literally spent like fucking 10 hours moving shit and driving. Okay, anyways.
You can modify the frequency range of the bands by interacting with the band.
What? You can modify the frequency range of the bands? What the fuck? This is so groundbreaking. Cookie dough can't be beat.
Regardless.
Okay.
For a 14-minute walk from the beach and there are ducks in the backyard.
Okay, cool. 14-minute walk from the beach. All right, that's pretty good. Snot flavor. What the fuck? How's your Trump impression? Not good. I don't really want to do it. Tillamook is really good. Don't sleep on pistachio.
Could have a slider.
Sleep on whatever.
This part provides
on
an overview of each band. Each of them incorporate.
Is this free? Like, if this isn't free, I don't know if I'm really gonna pay for a multi-band compressor. New music. Weaver Beats music video win. I mean, I'm willing to make some of my old music. I just don't know how I'm gonna. How's your throat, Weaver? Shut the fuck up, Ram. How's your throat doing, Ram? Let's see. Oh, is there an OTT function? Or what, maybe I was reading out. Hold on. Is it free? It just says download. Oh, it's $19.99. Okay, I don't know then. Did this just come out? Type plus one for Trump impression. Oh, God. What's a blee ass? Dude, it's a funny ass company name. That's what that is. Hawaii must be so sweet right now. It's pretty good. I don't really go to the beach that much, though.
It's an above and a below compressor. Thresholds are adjustable.
Huh? Yeah, we should.
By dragging the white horizontal lines.
Hmm. Maybe I might. I don't know. I need to get on my MF grind right now. You know, I did that Grimes video, which got a shitload of views. I need BWB impression. Oh my God. This is gonna be really hard. This not sound racist. This is gonna be walking on a tightrope. Me doing a BWB impression. I mean, I think I could do a pretty good BWB impression without, hey, 90K, dude. 90K on this fucking Grimes video. Let's fucking go. Let's go. I think I got limited ads on it though, but limited fucking ads. Let's go. Let's fucking go. Not really until you said that. Rick Beato impression. I don't think I could do that. I could do the BWB impression though, I think. Okay, should I do the BWB impression? 90K, nice. Yeah, dude. I think I'm gonna do one on the diss tracks. I wanted to do it the past few days, but I've just been too busy. Like, I wanted to do it last night after all the moving, and did not have the energy, dude. I didn't have the energy to plug in my monitors, like my, like, the audio monitors. Just do it. Should I do the BusyWorks Beast one? After we watch
you
this.
Can mute, solo, or disable compression on any band and adjust input and output levels as needed.
The Grimes trick is so lame. Bro, the funny thing about the Grimes video is so she has, apparently she has like a speech impediment. She has like a really bad lisp. And I was making fun of her for slurring really badly. Hold on, let me play the clip. Like, you guys be the judge here. You guys be the judge here. Is this someone with a lisp or somebody who's really fucked up? All right, Grimes DJ. Hey, let's check it out. I'm at the top. Let's see. Okay, here we go. This should probably work. Yeah, watch the video. Make sure you watch the video. That song's kind of hard. Okay, wait, hold on. You tell me. You tell me if this sounds like somebody fucked up, or you tell me if this sounds like somebody with a lisp. All right. It could. I don't think it could just be one or the other. Right. Here you go.
This
you
is
tell
a
me.
Difficult thing to explain, but we're having a major technical error where all the sound tempos are double speed, and I have not practiced the math because I'm not fast at math.
Grace, she definitely does have a lisp. I do hear the lisp, but I think she's fucked up.
Coachella performance didn't go as planned.
Oh my god, this fucking...
She couldn't keep the music.
Oh god, dude, who dresses like this? This is like a literal anime character. That's a literal anime character. I think it's both. There's nothing wrong with having a lisp. I have a lateral lisp, all right? Some may not know this. Some of you probably do know this because you were making fun of me for it. Dude, she's from my city, not her accent. Looks like a dehydrated bee. 2024 fashion. Bro, this is crazy, dude. It looks like she's wearing like a throne-style chair as a shirt. Do you really need to announce the tech? She did it like 10 times, dude.
Keep the music up. Check out the clip. Grace time tries.
It's a little clip?
Causing change. Something. It's a sad.
I don't want to hear. What is this fucking outfit, bro? I don't want to hear this guy talk, but.
Somewhat awkward.
This outfit, dude. Oh moment. My god, dude. Oh my god. Ah, god, dude. Like. Of course, there's like a picture of her reading the Communist Manifesto. Communist Manifesto. Look at this. I've seen this before, too. She puts out. What is wrong with you, Bronx? You need to go jack off right now. Like, seriously, I think you need to go beat your meat real quick and then come back here. All right. Come back and see us after. All right. So it totally makes sense now that there's a picture of her reading the Communist Manifesto just like this. Well, let me zoom in here. Like, this picture totally makes sense now. Wash your hands. Wash your friend. Well, first and after, really. Realistically. I mean, let's be honest, though. Most people don't do it before. Like, all this stuff, like, makes a lot of sense now, dude. This motherfucker thinks she's a fucking elf. She literally thinks she thinks she's an elf. But yeah, this outfit, like, it's all making sense, dude. She's like, she's one of those people that's like, I'm trying super hard to be really weird, you know? Like, do you believe me? Do you believe I'm fucking weird? Do you believe I'm fucking weird? Look at the weird shit I'm wearing. Look at what I put on my fucking hand or my head. Look at the weird shit I put on my body. You believe I'm fucking weird? Only a weird person would do this, right? Look at me. I'm reading the Communist Manifesto. That's pretty weird, right? She's actually quite hot. All right, shut up. Shut your mouth. You go join Bronx, man. You go get one out with Bronx, man. You guys need to go have a little meeting. You guys take care of that. Then come back to the chat, all right? All right, hold on. Okay. Brad, I guess you could read a 35-page book. Is that how long it is? I don't know much about the Communist Manifesto. Okay, let's finish looking at this here. We were just grifting at this point.
If you want more precise configuration for a bench,
I'm actually gonna post a vlog of like the second on the second channel of the move. Like, we kind of vlogged. There's actually some pretty dope ass shots.
You can exit.
Yeah, I don't understand why you would be like, I'm sorry about all the technical difficulties. Just do the shit and make less technical issues. I don't know.
Detailed settings here. You can adjust the threshold, ratio, attack and release settings for both compressors. The general...
I'm reading the Mein Kampf and then shaking my head constantly to let people know I disagree with it.
Section allows you to modify the input gain, knee setting of the compressors, and the look-ahead time. This option controls the...
Just like reading it, like... Do I have a book anywhere? Or at least this is my book. Oh... why did they write this? Why did they write this? Reading Mein Kampf, like, oh, dude, this is so fucked up. They wrote this, right? Just like on the bus. Yeah, maybe throw up a little bit. Ben pirates music software. Did we get a response? Oh, this has been fun so far. Go back to Grime. She's more fun. Oh, we got a response. I didn't write this. My chat made me do it. My live stream. I'm just going to throw you guys under the bus. I'm just going to throw you guys under the bus. They made me do it. They made me do it. Okay, we're going to ask Busy Works Beats tomorrow. Sure, blame it on the chat. Oh my god.
The attack of the three-pillar compressors, toggling between 2 times and 15 times the attack. Also featured in the general section is a unique...
So this just seems like a regular multiband compressor. Is there like a free multiband compressor? You can get OTT for free though. Like, you know what you want? You want a free linear multiband. This video is losing me. Yeah, the blue yass thing has lost me already. You know what we need? We need a free multiband compressor with linear phase. That's what you want. Because then you can do OTT without having the phase issues, which is like the main thing people complain about OTT with. Free linear phase multiband compressor. All right. Okay, so there's a linear phase multiband compressor for $29 from Waves. I don't know if there's a free one. Okay, wait, let's we're on a mission here, guys. We're gonna try to see if we can find a free linear phase multiband compressor, because that's gonna be your best bet for a free multiband compressor to use OTT, to do OTT with. Is that volume too loud? Is that good, guy? It doesn't really matter because it's my music. I'm sure there are. All right, let's see if we can find one, guys. TDR Nova. Oh, this might work because I think this has linear. Hold on. Reaper comes in one, but it's Aramaic. You mean archaic? I think you mean archaic. Because I don't think Aramaic makes sense in that context. Is it linear? I don't see linear is not showing up here. Does anybody know? The Communist Manifesto isn't like Mein Kampf whatsoever. Wait, did somebody say it was? I was just talking about how funny it is to read Mein Kampf and then shake your head a bunch. That's your music? It's too loud. Turn it off. I've used Reaper. I've used Reaper before. I wish I didn't. I'm looking for a free multiband compressor that's linear phase. That's the key part. Because basically the problem with using OTT is that it's not linear phase. So it fucks up the phase. This is linear. TDR Nova is. When I search for a linear, it doesn't come up. Nova's an EQ. Its functionality as a compressor is limited. This, hold on, what is this? ISP plugin, Linux Studio plugins. Let's see, multiband compressor. Is this VST? Okay. Because you want it to be, if you want something that's better than the OTT, that is OTT, you're going to want one that's linear. That's the best one. Because the problem with OTT is it fucks up the phase. So if you're doing like a saw bass or something, it's going to really fuck it up. TDR Nova is linear. Okay, so that's going to be your best bet then. I should reinstall this. Nova has linear settings. Okay, then. Oh yeah, there is one in FabFilter too, but I'm talking about free. Okay, cool. Problem with linear is pre-ringing. Well, I mean, I think if you're doing like a saw bass and you're doing like OTT on it, you know, your best bet's going to be you're better off with the possible pre-ringing than you are with whatever damage you may cause with the phase. Like, sometimes you got to weigh your pros and cons of like different options. All right, is there anything else we should watch, guys? I know next time we'll do Rate Your Studio and maybe music feedback after that. Let me see if there's anything else we should watch. I might have some other stuff queued up here. Stream content. Okay, we tried to watch this DJ Academics one. It kind of sucked. Kendrick tried to warn Drake and J. Cole. I could watch this because I would like to do more research on it. What do you guys think? Should we watch the Kendrick, Drake, J. Cole thing by Matty Walls? Or if you guys know any other videos we should watch real quick. Let me see if I can find something else real quick. This is Busy Works. Oh my God. Okay, that I'm going to require some grips for. Donate some money, Bronx. At least $10. Donate $10 and we'll watch Busy Works Beats. I'm going to grift for that. That I'll grift for, all right? That's going to be grifting. Next time Weaver's going to show us the studio, don't just ask one person. you know what's funny? Fucking Gifted Hater has a channel where he just exclusively reacts to Moist Critical. And it's like he's hating so hard in it. It's actually impressive. Like, I've never seen anyone hate that hard before. The Teenage Engineering thing, I think we reacted to it before. Let's see. Have you seen those videos, Ram? Bro, he hates so hard in it, bro. It is like so uncalled for. It really gives him like, it makes him seem like jealous or something. Busy features in a Tech N9ne song? Bullshit. No, we're not watching the fucking the Gift of Hater thing. I just saw that today. It's wild. What'd you see? I just talk about music off DistroKid having a moment right now. Let's see. Press 1 in the chat if I should make orange chicken for a midnight snack, or 2 to smoke and bowl, go to sleep starving. Let 1 probably. Let's see. I'm on Moist Rocket League esports team. What? It's called Everybody But Me by Tech N9ne. What do you think he paid for production credit on it or something? Hold on, let's see. Everybody But Me. Tech N9ne. I swear, dude, there's no fucking shot. Blizzy or Busy? This is not, bro, this is that's the wrong guy. I know it's way off brand, but I want to see you react to how desperately edgy JoJo Siwa rebrand is. Okay, maybe. We don't have anything to do right now. JoJo Siwa rebrand. Might get some shit for doing this on the second channel. Okay, this looks bad, dude. This looks bad. Alright, let's see. What the fuck, dude? How old is she now? Bro, what is going on, dude? What is going on, dude? So wait, was she famous on YouTube? Was that what it was? How old is she? She's 20, okay. Do not type that. Bro, oh god, dude. Disingenuous. You're on a list? I'm on a list on this. So she was a former Dance Mom star. What else? She's been doing some weird shit, dude. Like, what? God, I can't remember some of the stuff. She's a Disney kid, is she? Hold on, I'm trying to find some info on it. I don't want to watch a full video on it. I just want the clips. Maybe there's clips in this Reddit post. You have to see the video, it's so mediocre. Which one? She is peak grift. Dude, everything is grift. Let's see. Maybe I could just skip ahead to like this part where they show the videos about it. Oh god, dude. I hate this person's face. This is so Gen Z cringe, like Curtis Connor iDubbbz haircut. I hate this. I fucking hate this. I fucking hate this, dude. Like, why do people get this haircut nowadays?
Warning! The following content is not made for children and may.
Oh my god, dude. Oh my god. This is like as bad, if not worse. This is as bad, if not worse, dude. Hold on. Let me just. God, we gotta find the fucking clips, bro. Jesus Christ. No, I don't know. I don't know if we could take it, bro. I've seen some funny stuff about JoJo Siwa though. Like, I kind of want to pull up. Okay, yeah, but there's a music video here. Let's see. Maybe we could laugh at that. All All right, let's see. Oh my god, dude, this like the dislike count, dude. Oh my god. Dude, the fans are loving it, dude. The fans are fucking loving it, dude. Oh my god, dude. The fans are loving it. That's an insane ratio. She has 269K subs. And 1.5 million people are like, yeah, fuck this. Fuck you. It got 24 million views, though. Oh, this is awful, dude. This is so awful. Like, if she... The fact she's 20, like, I still feel uncomfortable watching this. You know what? I gotta shake my head while watching this. Just like an edgy rebrand if you're just gonna do, like, this generic-ass pop music, dude. You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't work together. It's such a fucking... It doesn't gel together. Like, it makes no fucking sense, dude. Can you turn the YouTube volume down, please? All right. Sorry. Can you turn it down? Like, and then just, like, keep turning it down until it's, like, at zero. It's like, okay, that's perfect. She should have done goth. Like, dude, like, the music... It's bad. Okay, wait. I want to find the clips, man. We need to find just the clips. Do you think... God. Because I know there's like TikToks and shit like that of it. That was JoJo Siwa. She's rebranding to like goth, generic, pop, edgelord, victim. Have you guys seen an episode of South Park? Wait, hold on. South Park. I like obsessively watch South Park. Come Hammer. I guess I'll just put rebrand. All right. Is it this one here? This is... Oh my god.
Okay, so let's see. How about this? Kyle. Wealthy, handsome, multi-talented, Grammy Award-winning victim.
Oh, that's what every rebrand is just a something, something, something victim. That's not playing. Already, there sorry, we go. Hold on.
I think we've put together some great ideas for your brand. I understand you want people to like you more and think you're cool. Is that right?
Yeah.
All right, well, let's see how this brand works for you.
You're kind of fucking up my brand.
We got Kyle, rugged, vegan, compassionate victim.
Victim. Victim.
I don't think that's really me.
Well, that's fine, because there's a lot of different brands people are attracted to.
But, like, is there something they're referencing with, like, the cum hammer thing? Like, I feel like they're referencing stuff. The procrastinator plugin is ready. Holy shit. We got to check this out, guys. That's huge. I'll be the first to test it, man. And I can watch South Park while using it. So this is working out perfectly here. Who is JoJo Siwa? I think she was like a famous YouTuber like 10 years ago, 5 to 10 years ago.
Kyle, sensitive, outdoorsy, frugal victim.
Victim. Weaver, hater, smokes crack, uses Reaper, homeless, victim. I don't use Reaper though. That's incorrect. That's just wrong. Dropped it in video submissions. Please tell me it works, dude. Or is it like you just have like a... Oh my god, dude. You fucking made it. If this gives me a virus, bro, there's no way it's going to give me a virus because this is WX Audio, the guy who made Nani. Okay, so it's a VST3. All right, this fucking... I'm going to be mad as hell, but I'm also going to be kind of stoked because I'm like, oh, at least I get to hop off stream. But at least I have a reason to hop off stream. Don't get me wrong, I like being on stream, but it is like a lot of pressure. It's so much pressure being on stream. All right, let me paste this here. All right, let's find out if this works, guys. We got the procrastinator plugin, but it only plays BWB videos. Oh, shit, dude. Dude, $1 million idea right here. All right, let's see. She's a huge brand, sells bright colored hair bows to 7-year-olds. Yeah, basically. Ben used to ghostwrite for Freddie Gibbs. Machine Drum actually has...
Waiting for this to launch here. Okay, let's see. Procrastinator. There ain't no fucking way. They might have to reload real quick. It's gonna take a second. I put it in the VST3 folder. Let me just rescan it. All right, let's see, guys. Does the procrastinator plugin work? Ableton, switch my mic. Oh, okay. Wait, hold on.
Okay, now it should work. Sorry about that. Heard some dolphins. Real voice exposed. All right. And Weaver said his stream's not fucked up. Bro, the audio's been good, though. I mean, not the audio. Yeah, the audio's been good, guys. No, the, what do you call? Sounds worse. Turn it off. The internet's been good. It's solid. Easy Wi-Fi, too. Okay, let me just switch this real quick in case he's pranking us. Procrastinator, let's see. Oh my god, dude. No fucking shot. Dude. WX Audio, dude. WX Audio, dude. Oh my god. He's really getting the W started. Check this out, guys. We have the Procrastinator plugin here. You can play stuff from YouTube. You can go to Weaver Beats. Wait, what is this? You go to Weaver Beats stream. This is on Weaver Beats stream right now. Shit you not. You click on it. Weaver Beats stream. And it fucking works. It's. You can hear my stream. And then you can click Hey Busy here. Ah, it goes to Busy Works Beats, bro. You should have had it play. Okay, wait. You should have had it play the Hey Busy sound effect. You shouldn't have it go to Busy Works Beats latest video. Oh my god. Can we get a download link? It's in I mean, if he's cool with it, it's in my Discord and video submissions. Maybe I'll just drop it in announcements. Is that cool, WX Audio? Can I drop it in announcements? But you got to edit it so the Hey Busy plays the Hey Busy sound effect. Just make it play the Hey Busy sound effect, and this is perfect. This is... You've... Oh, man. Wait, hold on. Dude, it's like... This reminds me of... Everything reminds me of South Park now. I'm like, dude, no way. It can play Wi-Fi. It can play videos, and it shits in Kyle's mouth. Hold on. It actually fucking works, dude. Oh my god. Holy shit. Babe. This guy in my chat, the guy who made the Drill Your Cheeks song, uh-huh. He made... Alright, let me just follow him. Like, guy, babe. Okay, hold on. Let me just repeat myself. Hey, babe, yeah. Okay, guy. Hey, babe. The guy in my chat who made the... You can just pop in if you want. He made the guy who made the... Okay. Alright. Well, she... The guy who made the Drill Your Cheeks song and the Nani plugin, he made a plugin in your DAW during this stream. He made a plugin during this stream where you can basically play YouTube videos in your... Somebody suggested this. You can play YouTube videos in your DAW, and it has a link to my live stream or whatever I think my latest video is. And then the Hey Busy button takes you to Busy Works Beats channel.
Oh my god!
I told him the Hey Busy button should just play Hey Busy, the sound effect though, but. Isn't that amazing? That's babe, look, babe, babe.
That's insane.
Babe. That's cool, right? Yeah. Can you drop the Hey Busy sound file and add it to the button? Yeah, yeah. I'll drop it in the same channel, the video submissions channel. Hold on a second. Dude, that's fucking awesome. Your girlfriend knows about the Nani plug. I explained it to her before. She's so wet right now. Oh my god. Oh my god. And the Hey Busy button does what? Should I do the one with the reverb and delay, guys, or the original? What do you guys think? I'll put both. Whichever one you think is better. What is that album cover? Which one? This right here? Oh, it's called Sip That, and it's got a anime girl drinking gasoline, as you do. Let's see. Oh, Sip That? Oh, yeah. She said she really likes Drill Your Cheeks, by the way. WX Audio. Make one for his Twitch page also. This is so meta. This is super meta.
I showed a bunch of people that song, too. I think it's hilarious, and it's actually really good.
She said that song is hilarious, and it's actually really good. What was I going to say? Yeah, he said thank you. Who is even saying Hey Busy in that sample? So if you want to know the lore of that, after the whole Busy Works Beats, Weaver Beats, video shit or whatever... Top tier Patreon access VST perk. That's actually not a bad idea. It's really up to whatever WX Audio wants to do with it, though. But basically, after that whole ordeal, some people in my chat started making AI stuff between me and Busy. Like, they would analyze, they had to analyze our voices, and they were making like these like joke conversations between us. And then for some reason, the AI made my voice sound really flamboyant. Like, I'm sure my voice sounds a little flamboyant, but it made it sound really flamboyant. And one of, and in one of the things, it's like, hey, busy. Hey, busy. So that's what that sample is. That's what the hey, busy sample is. The AI did it. It did do it. What's this procrastinator thing? It is a way to watch YouTube videos in your DAW. It's a VST3 plugin, and WX Audio made it because he's a king. But yeah, thank you for that. Is there anything else we should check out, guys? I guess we kind of checked out the JoJo Siwa thing. I think there's more to it, but I don't know. I don't know where to find the clips. Like, and I don't want to watch like all this crap. I don't want to watch this. Okay, wait. We got the TikToks here, and we can skip over this lady that looks like she's from the, you know, the 90s or whatever. Can you do like a loopback thing with it? I don't know. You could probably resample it in Ableton. So yeah, I'm not sure how the audio works with it. Okay, let's see. Let's watch the rest of this JoJo Siwa stuff. Okay, let's see. Okay. I don't want to see this girl's fucking commentary. No video sound. Okay, sorry. Yeah, I don't want to see this girl's commentary. I don't know. I don't like it. I don't like her commentary. Audio from the Vizzo. Are you talking about in the plugin or in this? Come on, I'm fixing it, guys. Hold on. Chill. Chill, man. Okay, I got it, guys. Audio's not working.
Like it or not? What's been in your head the last 3 days?
I don't know, Joe.
Wait, hold on. What?
Jojo, maybe it's because every...
Should we just go to our TikTok? Let's just go to our TikTok. I don't want to watch this dumb fucking bitch. I don't want to watch this dumb bitch. All right? I don't want to watch this dumb fucking bitch. If I'm being honest here. I don't want to... I don't like... It's not that I don't like Gen Z people, but I don't like people who embrace all the Gen Z aesthetics. You know, like the fucking haircuts, the baggy pants, the fucking... The septum piercing. I'm sorry, babe. I know some of this kind of sounds like you right now.
I don't have a septum anymore, and I don't wear baggy pants.
Okay. Okay. Good. Let's keep it that way. L, let's hear the ocean again. Okay. Wait. Sorry. We're going to TikTok. See, this happened to me just now. I was supposed to go to fucking. Okay. Here we go. You're so canceled on Twitter today. Do it. Fucking do it. What is it? It's JoJo Siwa. Okay, here we go. She got 45 million followers, dude. Jesus Christ. Okay, there's a lot of content to sift through here, dude. This is bad. Oh, this is really bad, dude. There's so much, man. Oh my God, this is bad. All right, let's just go from the top. Let's go from the top. Okay, why? Oh, okay. Boomer Weaver goes on rant about young people. I hate the young people. All right, let's skip over the pinned ones. Okay, let's just watch these. She needs to put the fork down? Guys, that's a bit mean there. Well, at least she's not a child. Live performance. Oh, man. These outfits are crazy. Okay, I want to find the funny shit. I want to find the funny shit. I don't want to see the performing and any of that crap. We need to see like you know, the skits and stuff. We want the skits. Bad. There's a Meat Canyon video about it. She's a kid. She's not a kid. We can go hard, guys. We can go hard. Video of her dance crumping is hilarious. Okay, where's that? That sounds funny. Hold on. God, there's just too many of these fucking videos, man. Maybe, you know, I can like let them autoplay and find them. Find the funny ones. Hold on. I didn't expect them to be, you know, making fun of JoJo Siwa on this stream, so I'm not really ready. I wasn't prepared for this. Okay, is this crumping? Okay, this is pretty fucking funny. I should just really mute the audio, I think. Should I play clown music? Is that too fucked up? Her head looks like a thumb. All right, guys. I want the skits, man. We want to see the skits. I don't care about the music, man. Dude, they're going hard on promoting this stuff. This is crazy. I can't even find shit. Hold on a second here. Maybe I'll just switch to the studio. Circus music. Or maybe I could play like one of those like worst beat ever thing. Boring ass music. One of those like worst beat ever things. You know what I'm talking about? Worst beat ever type beat. Worst beat ever type beat. Just skim through the Meat Canyon video. Let me play one of these. Oh my god, this shit's funny as fuck.
Yo, where's Louie?
There we go. This is my jam, dude. You're just hating, guys. There you go, guys. Got that new JoJo Siwa playing. I can't find anything that isn't her fucking music. I'm trying to find the cringe. I'm trying to find the cringe, and all I'm finding is cringe that is... Okay, wait, here we go. I think I've seen this one before.
Heaven phone call. This is a random heaven phone call, okay? Nothing...
Bro, she looks like fucking... What's his name? Phone vibrate type beat? Bro, what is it? God. Like Dog the Bounty Hunter, or like, She looks like she's about to drive a truck. Telling my kids this is a Joe Dirt, yeah. I want to call a trusted adult.
I'm too serious. If it was serious, I'd call grandma, grandpa, uncle I never got to meet. Someone like that. Unserious heaven phone call. Who are you calling? Personally, I'm calling the people in the Titanic.
She's lost her fucking mind, dude. What are they doing to these celebrities? Oh, you guys can't see it. Fuck. You can't see it right now. Here you go. Here you go, guys. Here's your treat.
If you could have one heaven phone call, this is a random heaven phone call, okay? Nothing too serious.
What are they doing to these child celebrities, bro? Like, what possesses you to do this? What possesses you, like, is this just for attention? Is it for attention? Because if it was for attention, this is working for sure, but...
Yes, if it was serious, I'd call grandma, grandpa, uncle I never got to meet, someone like
it's
that.
Like, God... Like, just screams trailer trash.
Unserious heaven phone call. Who are you calling? Personally?
Who are you calling?
I'm calling the people...
Dog the Bounty Hunter, bro.
Titanic submarine.
Look at that forehead. Sniper's dream. True that.
The situation, the submersible, that whole thing. I'm calling them. My friend said she would call JonBenet Ramsey. I feel like...
You know what it is? Maybe... Were you actually homeless? Yeah. I was homeless for like 2 or 3 days. I was living in a hotel. I wasn't living in my car. Although that was kind of almost potential on the first day because I couldn't get to my bank because the bank was closed on Sunday. What I was saying though is like people like who are like child stars and have like a mom that's like running their life and shit like that or like a manager, I think they're like molded in a way to where they just to accept orders, you know? So like they like can just be told what to do. And I think that's why how shit like this happens. You know, they're not saying no to this. Like, basically, like, someone's like, you know, hey, you can get so much attention right now just by, like, you know, making yourself look like a white trash piece of shit. And then they're just like, most people would be like, well, that's, I don't want it. That sounds embarrassing. But they've already been embarrassed their whole life. And they're used to accepting orders like this constantly in order to make it to the next level. So they just don't say no to shit like this. And then basically, they're just moldable. Weaver, do you like yeet? Not really.
It is?
Thank you. Why'd you get kicked out of the hut? I don't want to really get into it, but basically, like, I guess I'll give you, like, a vague explanation. I was living with my parents because I have a kid, and, you know, just kind of staying there because it's easier. And then, basically, I wanted to move out with my girlfriend, and she didn't have anywhere to stay, so I moved out of my house with her, and my parents don't like my girlfriend. So I moved out with her because my parents would not let her stay there, so I just basically, we were just like, fuck it until we could find a place. So it was like 2 or 3 days, maybe like 2 days. It was 2 days without like, it was 3 days. Yeah, it was 3 days without having a house to stay at. So I was staying in a hotel. So when we're basically just like calling and like messaging every single fucking place to try to find a spot to live at. Cause we're like, dude, we cannot stay in a hotel very long. This is going to eat up so much money, dude. My mom told me to make a channel like Weaver Beats. I told her no. That's yeah. Good. Yeah. Don't listen to her.
That's a pretty good one. Who are you calling? What are we asking?
Prayers for you. No, I'm good now. I got a room to stay in now.
Give me your take on this.
But it was like kind of fucked the first day because like my bank card was I was getting sent a new bank card, and then like I didn't expect all this to happen. Basically, I wasn't really planning on all this to happen, at least the way it did. So I on Sunday the bank was closed, and like I wasn't able to basically like use my debit card because it was closed and they were sending a new one. So like it was kind of hard to like fucking, you know, set anything up because the bank was closed. They weren't answering their phones, like, and they were like outsourcing it to some guy in India. Like it was so fucked. Like, but I got everything kind of straight now. So all right, let's see some more friends here.
First time out revolving sushi, and this should be fun because I only halfway like sushi. My brother was trying to play hard to get with the door, but I convinced
only
him
halfway
to
like
first,
sushi.
Now I can order for everybody.
Bro, I don't understand white people that don't like sushi or like don't like just foods from other cultures. Like fucking, I don't know. Like the fuck. Like what's wrong with you?
We walked in. This place actually.
Like, bro, like we went to, like recently we went to a, like a really good ramen place, like an upscale ramen place that's from Japan, that's in Milani, or sorry, that's where I used to live, in Hawaii. And like, it's funny, they have like white people food there also. Like they just have fries, like randomly they have French fries. Well, I'm not eating a fried tarantula. That's insane. But like, like I'm not eating a fucking tarantula. Fuck that. But like they literally have like French fries on the fucking menu. And it's like one of the things on there. It's like, bro, like what the fuck? Like, you really gonna cater to white people this much here? Like, it's fucking like, and then you look around and the white people always get fucking, they always get fucking fries, dude. Like, it's funny. And it's like, bro, you're at a ramen place. Why are you getting fries at a ramen place? That's insane. I mean, maybe if you can get fries and then like eat it with your ramen, that doesn't sound too bad. But Hawaii people food, yeah. Okay. Well, anyways, let's skip this one. We're trying to see the cringe bear. Okay, hold on. Starbucks is crazy. Really? Is the Starbucks what's crazy here, guys? Is the Starbucks what's crazy here, guys? Is that really? Because one of the comments here says the Starbucks is crazy. Really? You think the fucking Starbucks is what's crazy here? That's what's crazy here? Nothing else is crazy here? Nothing else about this is crazy here? Nothing about this is crazy here? Nothing else is crazy here, bro. Nothing else is crazy here, bro. Nothing else about this is fucking crazy here. The Starbucks is what's crazy here. All right, dude. No music talk? Am I on the wrong channel? Well, we're talking about JoJo Siwa. She released music. We're talking about cringe right now. We're talking about the cringe. Unless you got anything else to talk about music-wise. I don't know if we're going to be talking about too much music stuff tonight. I might save the rest of it for WNM. But I think I might close out the JoJo Siwa segment there. All right, thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you for following, donating, subscribing. I appreciate all that, guys. It's been a really fun stream tonight. It's almost 3 hours. That's pretty good. We'll do another stream soon, maybe even tomorrow, because I need to get on my grind, scheduling videos and streaming and stuff like that. But yeah, I'm going to do a video tonight, so we're going to have a video tomorrow, 100% for sure. Maybe even a second channel video tomorrow. But yeah, it's been fun, guys. Have a good Wednesday or Thursday, whatever it is for you guys. Peace, man.